Hello and welcome to the NSK Podcast, episode 257. This is the podcast about Japanese idols, and I'm your host, David Chang. I'm joined by Charlie Draco Cowden.
Yo.
Chase Starlancer PG Lim.
What's up?
And Serena Lam.
Hi.
You don't get a Twitter handle, because it's the same thing as your name.
Okay.
And you got a haircut. Look out.
I know.
What's going on here?
Look out.
Are you going through, like, early life crisis or something?
No, the story behind my short hair is pretty much I wanted a trim, like a hair trim, last week. But my dad's the one that usually cuts my hair. I told him to cut 2 inches off my hair, but he cut off 6. And then I asked him for side bangs. But he cut my side bangs, like, down here when I wanted them, like, up to my up at my nose or something. So later that night, my friends came over, and they said, "What's up with your hair? Like, it looks like Crystal from FX, like, that time, like, that new ABO music video."
Yo, there's nothing wrong with that.
And I said, "Oh, I wanted, like, side bangs or kind of like a layer. I didn't know." And she's like, "Layer? There's only 2 layers. And I said, "Okay, you have a point." And then she said, "Oh, I'll fix it." So we went into my backyard, and then she started cutting my hair, but I didn't realize she cut it like straight like this. And I said, "You're giving me short hair?" And she said, "Yeah, we can be twins." And I said, "But you know I hate short hair." And she said, "Too bad." And I said,
"Whoa!
Wow, what a great
That's so effed up.
Hold your hair hostage."
All of a sudden, like 2 minutes later, my other friend, because I had multiple friends over, my other friend had a pair of scissors, and she started cutting this side of the hair. It's better now, but before, there was, this side was like, obviously you can see it now, but this side was longer and more clean cut than this side. This side was like this short, and it was super choppy. And you could see, like, it was cut by 2 people. And my dad saw it the next day. Because they cut my hair at, like, 2 a.m, so my parents didn't see it until the next day.
Oh,
but my dad saw it, and he was, like, he just, like, like, deep sighed and said, "Drive to the salon." And I said, "But I don't wanna." And then he said, "No, do it now." And I said, okay. So I drove to the salon. Because I was planning on getting him to, like, clean it up on the weekend instead of the weekday, because I thought Sunday's family day, so he can cut my hair on family day. But then I realized it was better that way. So I went to his salon, and it took him an hour to fix the hair before this, because it was super choppy, and it was, like, cut by 2 people, so he didn't know, like, which way to go. And it wasn't even like one sitting, it was like, I sat down and he's like, "Oh, I'm done." And then I would walk around and he would just see me walk around, and he said, "Serena, come back, sit back, like, I don't think I'm done." And then it was like a good, like, process of maybe like 6 haircuts. Yeah, I think it was like 6 haircuts that day, where he would just call me back saying, "It's not perfect, you're not beautiful yet." And I said, "Okay." And then at the end of the day, like, after the 6th haircut, he said, "You're beautiful now." And I said, "Was I ugly before?" And he said, "Yes."
Yeah. Ouch.
Oh my god. So I had like 8 haircuts last week, and that's I've had more haircuts last week than I have in the past 5 years. Pretty
holy
much.
Holy crap. Well,
decade.
Oh no.
A good decade.
Oh, okay. Ugh. Serena, you're roboting kind of crazy back there.
I'm sorry.
What did you say?
I said that I had like 8 haircuts in the past week, and that's more than I had in the past like 5 to 10 years.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I heard that part.
That's pretty much it.
Oh, okay.
Good God.
Yep.
That sounds like an ordeal.
Well, if it's any consolation, I like your new haircut.
Yeah, before the podcast, I said I like it. I like it a lot. It looks nice.
Thank you. Yeah. My dad said it was beautiful.
Look at this picture of Terashima Yufu. It's pretty good.
Is that an interview?
Yeah, this is from the latest. Oh, this is not the latest, never mind. It's
so my hair used to look like that. But without the bangs. It's just a long hair.
You used to have hair that looked. Yeah, you didn't have the side bangs that Terashima Yufu has. Like, a lot of Japanese styles are like front bangs and then longer side bangs and then, like, just long everywhere else. Or, like, there's always, like, that reserved, like, area of side hair, which is pretty nice.
Yeah, that's what I had before the short hair. Just, like, two cuts. But yes.
Damn. Well, at least, I mean, you can make your hair look like Mayu's.
Her hair is pretty awesome.
Jesus. Did you see
Mayu's just awesome.
You see those pictures of her on that boat?
Yes.
Yeah.
No.
She was in, like, the sailor outfit, and it was great.
It was awesome.
She performed for 50 people on a boat. It was nuts.
It was like a karaoke cruise, dude.
Yeah.
It was awesome.
I went in on that. I gotta become Lawrence.
Yeah.
And go on a cruise just to see Tomochi.
Did he do that yet?
I think he did.
Has it even happened yet?
I don't know. I thought it happened or like the Australia and like Thailand or whatever. Jesus. I think it happened.
I was thinking she could go for like Sakura.
Yeah.
Oh god.
It's pretty similar.
Serena needs like a smaller face or something.
Oh yeah.
Like,
I thought my face started to look like bigger and fatter once I like cut the hair.
Oh.
But at least I like my collarbone, so at least like that balances out.
Yeah, one of my friends said that short hair on girls reveals like whether or not their head/face looks good or not. I'm like, shit.
You can't hide behind your long hair.
Yeah, you can't hide behind your hair. I'm like, damn, dude.
Whatever. My daddy says I'm beautiful, so I'm beautiful.
Okay, yeah, whatever.
It's like...
My daddy said...
My mom said I'm handsome.
My mom says I'm cool.
Yeah.
My mom said that... my mom... I'm not my mom's favorite child, but she said I'm still pretty cool.
Holy
what
shit.
The
Damn.
Jeez.
All
right.
Okay, so let's talk about Draco's shitty life. What's going on, man?
I worked on the house all weekend.
Oh, damn, what'd you do?
We were trying to put siding up on the garage. So we were preparing for that. Putting up plywood and tube of fours and whatnot.
Ah.
It was a pain.
Because so it's all not on the fun?
No, God no. It's all on the roof, and it's from the ceiling to the roof line, or what would be the ceiling inside to the roof line, so the attic space basically.
He did it from the window
to the walls.
To the walls.
I like walls. Oh, man.
I'm sorry, I had to throw that in there.
But yeah, that's what I did all weekend, was do that and work on a project that I can't reveal yet.
Okay. Watch, it's going to be something stupid again, like the when you were like, oh, that shit got translated. I'm just kidding. Alright, Chase.
No, that's not necessarily something stupid, but...
It could be.
The last one wasn't very good.
Depends on who you ask. I mean, for the idol fandom... Actually, no. For the specific people who wanted to watch it, of course it was cool.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, Chase,
yo,
what's been going on?
Quite a bit, actually.
Did you play more Guild Wars? Are you done with that game now?
No, I've been playing it still. I've been toning it back. I'm just slowly leveling a new Ellie, Elementalist, for PvP.
Damn, but, son.
But yeah, let me see. So, I had a... I've been, like, scoring a bunch of stuff recently. Like,
oh, baby.
Like, actually making music. Like,
oh, that's what you mean.
Yeah. We had What do you mean? What do you think scoring meant? Like scoring some coke or something?
Chicks, games.
Yeah, no, like music scoring.
music
scoring.
Yeah, I thought you scored music like scoring. Free stuff.
Yeah, I no, wish I wish.
Free yeah, like free loot.
I wish, but
I just scored a parking ticket. To be.
God. Win, hashtag winning. Yeah, so I've been composing some Spanish music for my class, which is cool. Yeah, it's and then it's gonna get we're gonna record it in studio with session guitarists and like make it into an actual thing. So that's cool. I've been watching a crap ton of anime recently. I've been watching a Bakemonogatari.
Oh
yeah, it's pretty good.
Well, you've never watched it before?
Nah, I'm watching it for like the first time.
Wait, have you seen the other Monogatari series? Or the...
Nah, I'm gonna watch it in order of release instead of chronological, because I figure I'll just get it anyway. And I'm getting that Shaft like.
Oh yeah, you
like
are.
Like the Shaft addiction. Now it's like
addicted to the Shaft.
Yeah, and it's like I don't know. It's really cool. I'm like, it's great because Hanakana, my favorite VA, Hanazawa Kana, voices what's her face? She voices that chick who shows up in like episode 9 to 10, but like,
what?
Oh my god! Okay.
She's the one that sings Renai Circulation. But, yeah, I don't know. It's, Bakemono is great.
Wait. She's played by, Horie Yui, right?
No.
Oh, no.
The VA's name is Hanazawa Kana.
My bad.
Yeah. Yeah, so, that one's cool. I'm still burning through,
Each VA sings,
Yeah, they sing their own.
They sing their own. So you like the the Snake Girl, right?
Yeah, Snake Girl's... Yeah, well, just because of her VA, mostly.
Renai Circulation's a pretty awesome opener.
Yeah, it's, like, I basically started watching it because I wanted to watch that OP.
Oh, because
like,
you had heard the smoke weed version of it before.
Well, I heard like multiple fucked up versions of it. So I'm like, all right, I gotta
like hear. That shit gets remixed to hell. I don't know why.
It's hilarious, dude. It's like one of my favorite like mashup songs to listen to. And yeah, actually watching. The anime that it was from was pretty cool. And it's funny how starkly like opposite the opening is from the tone of the actual anime.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, alright, so it's like this like happy Renai Circulation thing.
Yeah.
And then it's like, alright, let's watch this girl get like constricted to death by two invisible snakes. Like, alright, this is awesome. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Indeed.
It's kind of cool how they balance like the humor and the horror kind of aspect, or like the suspense kind of aspect, so that was cool. Besides that, stuff that's airing right now, I just finished Shimaneta, or A Boring World Where Dirty Jokes Do Not Exist.
Oh, I finished it too.
Yeah, it was one of my favorites this season. It's basically sex jokes come to life. It's like sex jokes the anime. Or sex actions, the anime, without being ecchi, which is pretty cool. It's like a non-ecchi show that just deals... Well, actually, no, it's pretty ecchi.
Okay.
I don't think so. It's not that
It's
bad.
Just basically it's just Anna. Anna's the only source of ecchi, and they use that as, like, a funny playoff point.
She, like, sits on him.
Yeah, drink
like...
my love nectar.
Yeah.
Please.
She's like dripping stuff.
Yeah. I baked my love nectar into these cookies. Now
eat so
these
gross.
Cookies.
That was the worst joke. Oh my god.
I was just like cringing. I'm just like, oh god, it tastes so bad.
That's just
the yaoi thing too? Where like the jokes are like, oh hey, you should like rub your banana against his banana and what would happen.
You
and
mean
then,
with
like,
the MC and Goriki?
Yeah. Oh my god.
Okay, this
just the appealing. The undertone, like what? the gay undertones that they throw in are just like absolutely hilarious. It's like, okay, this does not belong here whatsoever, but we're gonna play it through anyway, and it ends up like being a really funny comedic relief.
Yeah, it's very like dirty joke comedy.
Yeah.
But it's like really playful.
Yeah. If you've watched SYD before, Setokai Yakuin Domo, you'll be a big fan of this one, because SYD is basically sex jokes the anime also, or mm-hmm. sex puns the anime. So yeah, watching that, Monster Musume just aired this last episode. I'm like 3/4 of the way through it. I'm almost done with the last episode. That one's ending. Prison School is ending this
Prison week. School.
That one was really great as well, because Hanazawa Kana voiced someone else in there, and her persona is like incredibly psychotic. It's mm-hmm. hilarious.
There's also a live action drama coming out.
I'm not watching that because I feel like it's gonna. I mean, they got the look of the people down really well, but
yeah, so far.
Yeah, but I don't know. I've just never been a fan of live action anything that was originally
Attack
an anime.
On Titan.
Yeah, I'm not watching that either. So yeah, Prison School and Shimaneta were like the funniest things, and then yeah. Overlord, watching that. Yeah, that's about
it. Have you watched Himoto Umaru-chan?
I watched the first episode, or I watched like the first two episodes. I wasn't too into it for some reason.
That series is my second favorite for this season.
Yeah, really cool. I started a bunch of things. Like, this is the season where I've watched the most currently airing anime for some reason. And I have no idea why, but yeah, I was like watching 7 at one point, and that was a lot. That was
a lot
like for me.
We need to have an anime podcast.
A 2D club?
Yeah,
discussion.
Like a 2D club or a Superflat Media.
Mm-hmm. Let's get Day back in here.
Yeah, talking to you, Day Lee. Bring back your anime podcast.
Yeah.
Too bad, Chase, you don't live near us at all, though. So.
Yeah. I live near Yoshi. We're trying to get some, like, bi-monthly or monthly thing together, but we're still trying to work it out.
It's gonna be, like, another year or two before
yeah.
I even see
I'm gonna graduate and move back to California if I
Yeah, don't. Yeah. It's all right. I'm ready to meet up. I'm back in California.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's basically my life. I've been watching anime, playing games, making music.
Yep, yeah. Sounds like a college student.
Yeah, man.
Yep.
What did you do, Dave?
I went to a convention called TohoCon.
Oh, you did?
I staffed it.
How was it this year compared to last year, actually?
It was cool. It was like nearly 5 times bigger in terms of attendance.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's really grown. We not took up entirely, but we used 2 floors of the hotel. It was a different hotel this year. But around the same area, pretty much in the same area. It was a 3-day con this year instead of 2. Tons of guests and a lot of happy cross-dressing dudes everywhere.
Nice.
Yeah. Were there, like, improvements or, like, any complaints? I know last year there was, like, a really big drama that they had to apologize for.
Yeah. That didn't
happen
again.
What happened last year?
Some rogue staff members, like, got into a guest of honor's hotel room and partied in it.
What? Wait, with the guest of honor there?
No. Yeah,
like
not with the guest of honor there.
Yeah, they kicked the guest of honor out of the rooms, kind of.
No, they entered it. They didn't? See, they entered it thinking that he was gone, like he was done with the room, but he wasn't. He hadn't checked out yet, and they entered
his
room.
Was it like
room.
A Japanese guest of honor?
No, there weren't any Japanese guests of honor. Wait, were there? Shit, I don't remember. But no, and he came back and it was like,
they
holy shit, who are all these people? And like, all my camera equipment is out too. And yeah, it was pretty bad. I was just like, who does this, you know? Yeah. So like I'm pretty sure that entire group of staffers was like blacklisted or whatever. I don't even know who they were, so, but...
The guests?
The staffers. Because that's surprising, because I staffed last year, too, so I was like, what the hell? But, yeah, it was, that didn't happen this year, thank goodness. not really, like, customer-facing drama this year, I don't think. So that's a start. I got to see our bro Marco again, because he brought his car crew and friends over to show off their Tasha, which literally means
rice rocket.
No, painful cars, because they decorate the whole things with vinyl wraps of anime or other nerdy things.
Oh yeah, he had that like. I saw that video that you had. He was, like, doing the dance to a Halloween night or something.
Oh, yeah.
Ambulance?
Yeah.
No, that was it was Halloween night.
Oh, it was Halloween night. Yeah, and he had, like, it's like, he was, like, blasting it out of his, like, his Weeaboo car.
Oh, no, it was a portable speaker he had. But...
Oh, it was? Oh, I thought he tricked out his car with some, like, awesome, like, 10-inch subs and, like...
No, he just hides the speaker inside his hood.
Aw.
But, Yeah. Toho Khan's Twitter did show a Vine or a video of his car, and he has like a 2010 photo of AKB-48 on the hood.
Yeah, that's tight.
Yeah,
I mean, I wouldn't have the courage to rock it, but props to him.
Yeah, it's freaking intense. But yeah, staffed the convention, met up with a bunch of old friends, met some new people. Kind of had fun. Yeah, it was pretty much. Yeah, it was a good time. It's just staffing is always gonna be like somewhat tiring, you know. So I'm always like, shit, I took time off to do this, you know. But it's cool. I still like conventions in general. So mm-hmm. Yeah, that's about it for me, I think. Yeah.
Speaking of things to watch, has anybody seen the preview of the show Akimoto Asayaka's in?
No.
No.
Is she in the drama?
I thought it was a movie.
I'm not sure if it's a movie or a drama. It's,
Or maybe she's doing both.
Well, this is listed under movies on Wikipedia, so I'm guessing it's a movie. But it's a spinoff of the Gato series. I don't know how many people have watched that, but it was kind of a dark, like, tokusatsu show that has had several series and movies in it. God, I can't even remember when it started. I watched it, though, the first one. But, no, there's a preview of it out for on YouTube.
Is this the one where she's, like, from... Like, not ancient Japan necessarily, but more like medieval Japan, and it's transported to the future? Okay.
No, this is, it's a very fantasy, type action show.
Fantasy called... set in modern Japan.
Yeah, it's kind of a demon's...
No, I have seen the preview for this.
It's kind of a Demons Live Among Us type thing, and...
Yeah, I mean, I thought she was from medieval Japan because of the way she was dressed.
Oh, no. No, that's just the way they dress.
Okay.
What's it called again?
Biku? Biku Yamigiri Nochi.
Huh.
And she's the lead actress in it.
Oh, that's cool.
It looks like a really freaking awesome show.
Damn, she looks freaking fierce.
Yeah. She looks like she's going to take somebody down.
Yeah, this is totally a movie, because they said roadshow.
Yeah.
Looks like there's a budget behind it.
Cool. Oh, yeah.
I mean, the CG is still very CG-ish, but it looks like a higher production than we're used
to
seeing.
Well, if you ever watched Gato, that's, there's a budget behind it. The CG in that was spectacular.
Yeah, man. Akimoto Sayaka is like... she's like... She's like that fierce female lead role. It's like, I'm surprised she hasn't been in higher the band since.
Actually, I was just looking at her on Wikipedia. She's starring in 3 movies coming up.
Yeah, I'm just surprised it didn't happen sooner.
And she's in several TV shows, too. Yeah.
So. Maybe I'm just stupid, which I probably am.
Top Keck.
Yeah.
Well, she's doing, like, everything. I mean, she's doing musicals, freaking stage plays, dramas.
She's doing movies. Pretty damn good for herself.
Yeah. I mean, can I get, like, a Akimoto Tano combo going here? That would be pretty freaking cool.
Yeah, dude. Tano can just be mini Sayaka.
Yeah.
She's like her sidekick.
We'll get to that later.
Okay.
Yeah, I was wrong. She was ever since she graduated, like, she's been doing, like, she did like she did like 2 dramas per year, and now more recently she did 2 movies in 14.
We just don't hear about it because either we don't know enough like dedicated Akimo fans or whatever.
Or yeah. The news sites that we frequent don't
cover it.
Yeah. That's really cool. I'm really glad she's doing well.
Yeah. I think, like, she also does a lot of stage plays, right?
Yeah,
that's a regular thing for
her. She's in Sherlock Holmes 2 Bloody Game this year.
Damn.
Well, that's a musical.
Yeah, she did Ega last year.
Yeah.
Okay.
Roman Holiday in 2012.
Yeah.
She's a busy bee.
Yep.
Yeah.
Alright, that's cool.
That's something I'll be looking forward to seeing.
Alright. Well, we covered part of our news already.
We did?
Well, I mean, that kind of counts as news.
Yeah.
What makes you nervous? Being in the car of someone who drives like shit and someone asked if it was Serena?
Isn't that the same thing?
Oh, yes. Man.
Wait, is that pointed towards me?
No. I've never been in your car.
Yeah.
I don't want to be.
Wow. Oh, I see this. the tweets.
I think the question is, makes you more nervous? Being in the car with somebody who drives like shit, or having people who drive like shit around you?
Probably around me, because that's just more chances for wreckage.
I mean, I drive like shit, but I avoid like a pro.
Whatever.
No.
Whatever.
No. It doesn't really work like that.
It's okay, you'll still survive.
I'm not confident.
Okay, let's talk about the idols. Since the time is now. First up, let's talk about a group called C-Style. What the hell?
Have we covered them before?
No.
I think they're brand new.
Believe so.
Yeah. I thought this was Chinese or some shit. But this is,
some this really is called
Kishidan? God damn it! Is it really? Because these kanji, so to speak, are done in like Chinese style, like the one for ki. That's totally chi in Mandarin. Like that's not the way the Japanese write it.
Trying to be edgy.
Yeah, and then this other one is like, what is this?
Idan, hidan.
I don't know. What is this, Serena?
What have you done to us?
Serena put this in?
Yeah.
I didn't put it in, but like I did put this in the podcast.
What? So you put this in?
Yeah, I did. I was thinking of something else for a second. But yeah, I just kind of, I didn't really know how to translate it. I just wrote Kidan because that's the Romaji. But all I know about the group is that they're like, I believe they existed for 2 years now, but this is their very first PV.
Wow.
The indie idol life.
And it's all like super acoustic and everything.
Yeah.
The group itself is like a Yankee style.
Yeah. This is kind of cool.
Group. The director is Ninomiya Yuki, who has worked with like a lot of people. He's mostly known for like Omori Seiko music videos, I believe. If you know who she is.
I've heard that name before.
Yeah, she's a solo idol artist.
Mm-hmm. Her music videos are usually pretty... they're kind of in your face. And she moves around a lot. But this is like a really big contrast because it's not like something crazy. It's very acoustic and pretty.
It's funny because in all the performance shots, it looks like they're like walking onto the stage to some like super intense music, whereas yes, in this music video, it's just like yeah.
Yeah, I don't know much about them. I just know that they're not very known and they've lasted for quite a while.
Yankee idols eating corn dogs.
Pretty much.
Them obscure idols.
They're coming out with an album, their very first album, too. But apparently there's only like, I don't think it's like really an album because I looked at the track list and there's only 3 tracks.
Oh, miniature album, AK single.
So I think it's like a single album.
A single album? F that. Jesus.
Get out of here.
Yeah. Yeah, this is, I saw this, but this is definitely not what I was expecting.
Out of this group, or just in general?
I'm not expecting Yankee idols to be singing a ballad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or anything that I could remotely, like, understand at all.
Yeah. Especially because it's, like, their very first PV, too, but it's not even, like, a really Yankee-style song, but more of an acoustic song.
I mean, if you're gonna stick with the Yankee identity, you should, like, do, like, a powerful or, like, empowering PV, you know? Like, a fierce song and style.
Yeah.
You'd think?
Yeah. That's what I would have expected.
Yeah, I was gonna say, you know, where's my surf guitar?
Yeah.
or my rock and roll.
Especially with a song like Kishidan. You know, that's like that other group that I can't think of the name of now. Dang it.
What, the rock group? Like you're talking about what I think you're talking about?
Oh, no. What were you saying?
Well, they're just... Isn't Kishidan the name of the group?
Yes, it is the name of the group.
Yeah.
With the lead singer is the guy who was DJ Ozma back in the day.
Yeah,
that fits more the Yankee style than this does. This just doesn't feel
very Yankee to me.
Doesn't feel authentic to the style or the theme of the group.
Yeah. Oh well.
Yeah.
That was interesting.
C style.
I guess it depends. What does this C mean?
I'm actually not sure.
Cooking style. All right.
Cocaine.
Cool. Cocaine style.
Cake.
Corn.
These guys aren't under AVEX, right?
I don't
think so.
I don't think so. I believe there's some under like
I saw a related video, and I was like, oh, look, it's them live. Oh, no, it's Scandal live at Kishidan Banpaku 2013. Because it's Mommy wearing, like, a similar uniform. And I'm like, oh, okay. Let's read more about them. Go to their website, c-style1.com. That one chick with the colored hair looks kind of like, you know, Shibuya K, kind of the Tomochin of the group.
Like, this isn't even, like, their own YouTube channel either. J-Tex. This is, like, a promotional channel for, like...
Yeah, what is this? Japanese channel. Then what is this?
Yeah,
whose channel is this?
This is the director's channel.
Yeah. Oh!
They have their own YouTube channel, and it's mostly, like, stage performances and little, like, vlog clips.
Jesus.
Yeezy?
Jesus. Jesus Yeezy. Man, this website is, like, straight out of 1990.
GeoCities.
Yeah. Like, just look at the JPEGs. You can see the artifacting on their buttons.
And, like, every link links to a different page, or...
Oh, it's so bad! Who made this? Oh, my God.
Or website entirely, in some cases.
Welcome Beautiful. To Web 1.0. Well, that's All cool. Right. I think I'm gonna add this to my list.
Scrolling Achievement.jp?
Never heard of them.
Well, one of the email addresses is c-proentertainment, so I don't know if that's the agency, like, upstarts. Or...
Yeah, maybe.
I'm not sure if that's the agency or what.
Guess we're gonna have to find out if they ever become more successful.
I just take this as an example of how hard it is to, like, break out of the indie idol scene, because, like, we're a website that covers indie idols, or, like, idols in general, and we've never even heard of these guys before.
Well,
yeah, I just happened to find out about this through the, like, director.
We might not be doing enough of a job.
Yeah, that's true.
But yeah, no, it's got to be hard to break out in the scene, because, like, well, for at least internationally, to get any recognition internationally, you know. You need to be on YouTube. You need to have some sort of, like, interaction with others that would allow you to be promoted.
Well, it looks like you can get a two-shot for 500 yen.
Wow, yeah. That's cheap.
Yo. Yeah, two-shot, checky, 500 yen. T-shirt, 3,500. Towel, 1,500. Oh, yeah,
like, so how much is your parking ticket, Serena?
My current one or my last one? My current one, 41.
Both. Okay.
My last one, 93.
Oh, okay, God. So Naruse needs to pay $93 in order to experience the ride of his life, right?
Oh my God.
What do you mean by the ride of his life?
He has to get into Serena's car. And
what?
And then she'll navigate LA, downtown LA traffic.
Never
That'd
again.
Be great.
Just hire an Uber.
I hate driving in LA. Parking's the worst.
Yeah, because you just get tickets all the time because you don't know where to park.
It said 1 hour of parking.
Did you park for an hour?
Yeah. I came back at, like, 50 minutes. But, like, I the officer told me, oh, the 1 hour parking zone, it's only the first half of the street. You parked right, like, where, like, it splits off and you're in the second half of the street. And I was
wrecked.
Just thinking, what? There's not even a sign. Like, how am I supposed to know? But, yeah, he still gave me a ticket. So I paid it off yesterday. And now I got one this morning.
Yep, this is your life. Okay.
In front of my house, too.
All right. So we just talked about Kishidan by C-Style. I'm pretty sure it's Kishidan now at this point.
Yeah.
The X is gonna be
That's what my sources say.
Yeah, so let's talk about this cool music video by this group named Gem, because of Precious Stones. This is called Baby Love Me. I've been pretty excited. This is, here's your Avex Idol group for the night, Chase.
Yeah, here's your short version.
Yeah.
Why?
AKA the entire thing.
Yeah. Short version, 4 minutes, 33 seconds.
The last 5 seconds get cut off because Avex.
Excellent.
Like, I'm almost more mad that Avex does that than, like, say, King Records only gives you...
2.5 minutes?
A minute and a half.
Yeah.
It's like, at least you know what to expect. When I come to Avex and it's a short version, I don't know whether to expect a minute 30 or 5 minutes 30.
Yeah.
6.5 minutes.
It's like short drama version abridged. Promo version.
I'm very glad that, like, at least predominantly with 48 Group, they've been dropping that shit. The drama versions of stuff.
That was getting really old.
Yeah.
I didn't realize that.
Most of this PV, from what I saw, is virtual reality.
Wow. Yes. Yo, you know this set? You know what it looks like?
No.
Or you know what location this might be? It's the same, like, it looks like the same one that Fairies did Tweet Dream in.
Oh, what?
Does it not?
Possibly.
Not really.
What?
Tweet Dream had the, had all that random, like, white crap, like, the white objects everywhere.
I thought they had the arches in the statues. Indoors.
Oh, no, let me go watch that again now.
It would be hilarious if they did, if they are using the same venue.
I remember that because Tweet Dream is, like, my favorite various song, but...
Oh, one of God, my no, really?
Or it was, or it's, like, my, it's, like, the most memorable one to me. Cause they're like FOMO, FOMO, tweet, tweet.
Okay, you're right.
Bling, bling, my love.
Like that's like one of the few I remember.
Bling, bling, my love.
That one was my favorite music video.
Or like, yeah, Beat Generation is probably my favorite, but you know, whatever.
I like the White Angel.
I didn't like any of them, so.
You're a piece of shit. That's why.
I never got into Fairies.
No, it's different. They have a checkered floor.
Yeah, wait, okay, no, I'm... Oh, man, which song is it, then?
What, is it, like, Cupidron or something?
No, like... This... The indoor shots look really familiar, but... Yeah, I don't know. Like, I swear Fairies has performed there before.
If anything, it reminds me more of, like, Anger Me or something than...
Right, but that's because Anger Me's been, like, inside mansions for the past... couple months.
Yeah.
That's true. No, didn't I have that one song where they were just like in a warehouse, like an empty warehouse with
every idol has to be in a warehouse at some point in her life.
The new Morning Musume groups have been using the new Hello Project groups have been using warehouses a lot recently.
The Morning Musume groups.
When I think, Hello Project and Morning Musume are really synonymous in my mind.
Well, yeah, they're the flagship group.
Yeah, so I get the two mixed up a lot, but you know, whatever.
How about that AKB girl? No, that's Jarena.
I'm having trouble. I'm having trouble hearing you, Serena.
Oh, I said that gem doesn't disappoint.
For real.
What's up with the half skirts, man?
I really like. Yeah, because it's like shorts
I've
and then like
disappointed.
Flared out skirt things.
At least they're not a different color from the main outfit. You know, because I remember this other group had that, and that really bothered me.
I also like their one-inch heels.
The one-inch heels?
Because it's very,
They're dancing heels.
They're very sustainable heels.
It's better than five-inch heels.
Right.
This isn't, what's that one group that, is it X21 or, Especia that dances in, like, 4 to 5 inch heels or something?
Well, they're also really tall, right?
Yeah.
Fairies, dances in heels, too.
Fairies dances in really, really tall heels.
Oh, yeah.
They're
intense. Did that one video last year, and they were dancing outside on the concrete in, like, 4 or 5 inch heels.
Yeah, but they can do
ridiculous.
I remember them doing, like, practice sessions, and the dance instructor yelling at them because they couldn't dance in heels.
Damn.
It's the worst. If you guys ever try it, you will not last one song on the dance floor. It's the worst.
I wouldn't even want to. I wouldn't put anybody through that.
If you men ever want to try it,
I've seen girls break their heels, even short heels like that, dancing.
Yeah.
Short heels are.
What?
There goes that robot.
Say that again. Sorry.
Heels are easier to dance in, at least because there's less weight on your toes.
Yeah, I think it was Bling Bling My Love, where they were dancing in like 5-inch heels and like walking down the street.
That's because they're in LA. In
Hollywood.
Yeah.
That was a pretty good song.
All right. Yeah, as stupid as that song is, it's pretty
so
freaking
catchy.
Good. Yeah,
it's really funny because it's a ripoff of a Zed song.
Oh really?
No, never mind. That was Kikkawa You, which is about to come up. It was no, I covered it in my end of the year awards last year, where I was like, yeah, this fairy song is basically a blade. Oh no, it was Kesha's TikTok ripoff. That's what.
I found it.
Yeah.
It does kind of sound like TikTok.
Yeah.
Hey, guys, go look up Fairy Sparkle. Oh, I posted it in the Ustream chat.
Fairy Sparkle?
This is the same goddamn place.
Is it really?
Yes. Look at it.
Sparkle.
I have to sit through a 15-second...
No! Skip to the middle! God, you can...
Have to sit through the Mountain Dew ad first.
Oh, great. Get some ad block.
9 seconds.
No! The new YouTube ads are unblockable. I can't block them.
Switch to a different ad blocker.
Yeah, get ad blocker.
Oh my god, this is the same set!
Yeah, see, it's the same place!
Holy shit, the floor is the same!
You have to... Why me...
Oh my god.
This is amazing.
This is the exact same set.
This is the first time we can like undeniably confirm this is the same filming location.
No way.
Dude, this is from 3 years ago? Holy crap.
Oh my god. They didn't even change
it.
It
looks exactly the same.
Jem, you thought you could get away with this? No, I'm just kidding.
God damn it, Jem.
Jem was just trying to save him some money.
I'm fine. I mean, it's Avex after all, right?
This is hilarious.
This is great. Let's just watch Sparkle now. Oh my god.
Shit.
Wait, is it the same trees too?
What do you
there
mean same
trees?
There are trees in the gem one.
I don't see any trees in the fairies one.
At the staircase with the little like
All right, you know what's hilarious is I can watch both of them.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, no, they don't have the trees. Yeah, no trees.
That's like their addition. They're like maybe they won't notice if we throw in some foliage.
you can't freaking like.
No, you can't hide that.
Those arches are so distracting.
The
like,
arches are like almost iconic in a sense.
Yeah, this is part of that building specifically.
Yeah.
At least Jem like put. A lot more lights and
lights. They put lights and shit in it.
Yeah. Well, so did fairies, but they did it like runway style.
Yeah, they put them on the ground. There's like black like runway lights, and then fairies just put these background ambient.
Fairies is just in another J.J. Abrams Star Trek movie. It's like, holy shit.
That's funny.
Yeah. Granted, they also use outdoor scenes, so it's not like they, you know, fairies use the entirety of, like, I think their entire music video was just that building.
Yeah.
Whereas in the Gem music video, they do the plain clothes, walking around, like, looking at the bay and stuff like that type of scenes.
So. And dancing and with the virtual reality glasses.
Yeah, the glasses as well.
And then transforming into the quote-unquote virtual reality set.
Yeah.
So the
they
real
became
question
fairies! What's the
who
real question, Serena?
Better?
Ooh,
which venue
looks
better?
Who danced the venue better?
Jem.
I think fairies.
No, I like Jem because they actually make the place look poppin'.
I actually do like Jems more.
I think it's just they use like the video effects and the lights and the flares.
Yeah, I mean they got a three-year advantage.
Yeah. We got better
Learning
technology
from
now.
Fairies.
Yeah.
We have the
but
technology.
I think I like the song, like, more in general. So.
I don't remember what fairies... I don't remember what Sparkle sounded like.
Exactly, and you just watched it, so...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'm really digging this Gem song. I like it a lot.
It's pretty good, yeah.
My favorites are, well, naturally my favorite is Red, Takeda Maya, because she's front and center. But one of my other favorites is Maho, the one that's orange. Naturally, she has to be one of the younger ones. It's terrible, but it's because when I saw them perform, like, she caught my eye a lot, because I was just like, she smiles a lot.
Wait, when did you see Jim?
Last year.
Saw him in Japan?
Yeah, in Japan.
Saw him in Japan?
Oh, wow. That's cool. At the At Jam Festival.
Oh.
Remember, that was the time where, like, we had, like, a 6 to 8 hour concert?
I don't even remember that.
But it was great, because, you know, I saw a bunch of groups. Like, I think I like that setup the most out of all, like, idol shows. Well, mm-hmm. I don't know. It's tough to say, but, like, if you want a crash course on idols, like, going to, like, an At Jam, Tokyo Idol Festival, or any one of those, like, here's a bunch of idol groups in one day type of thing, like, those are, like, the best. Because you'll get, like, a half hour set or less of each group, and mm-hmm. you can just be like, oh, if I like them, then I can follow them.
Mm-hmm. I think At Jam's probably better because they generally don't have, like, multiple stages.
Oh, yeah. See, Tokyo Idol Festival is, like, you know, that's the Grand Prix of idols. You go there and you're just like, holy shit, whatever. It's like Comic-Con, but idols. And you're just like, I can't see everything, you know. Whereas, At Jam is just one
long,
stage.
Really long show.
God, oh, the standing and then the funk. In the front, yeah, oh my god.
I'm sure.
We got the funk!
Disgusting. But it was great. Anyway, so, yeah, Maho caught my eye, because she has, like, the chipmunk cheeks, and she smiles all the time, so. And I was like, she's really cool, and I was like, oh god, she's like a freaking baby. But they're cool.
This song reminds me a lot of, like, a Supergirl song.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Really?
Yeah.
I think, yeah, the style and, like, the chorus.
I feel like Supergirls, they're more, like, cheery pop.
Yeah.
And then Jem has more, like, dance pop to them.
Well, cheery pop?
It sounds more like cheering, like little girls cheering for their little, like, other friends.
Little girls, Jem?
Little girls cherry
no,
pop.
Super jerk.
Little girls cherry pop.
Oh my god. So Pizza Ghost says I need to call them by their gem colors and not their actual colors. So Takeda Maya's Star Ruby. And Iyama Maho is Fire Opal.
What? That's like Crayola, like Crayola naming their crayons like macaroni and cheese.
I mean, but they do that.
Yeah, but they're actual gems.
That's true.
Wait, where the hell? Okay, hold on. I think the Wikipedia is not up to date on gem. I need
that
to go to Generation or
something.
Surprise
me.
Yeah, let's see.
I don't know any of these girls, so.
I don't know any of them.
I know our buddy Vu, his favorite is Murakami Rana. Or they spell it with an L, Lana. She's Emerald.
Ooh.
Emeraldo.
Emeraldo is my birth.
Well, yo, what color is amethyst supposed to be? Oh,
purple.
It's a purple. Okay.
Purple.
What is citrine? Oh, it's like citrus. Wait, what's the difference between citrine and fire opal?
Citrine is yellow.
Oh.
Citrine is really close to topaz.
What? How do you know this, Draco?
Because I was into rocks at one point.
Oh, yeah, you would be.
I was actually really into gems at one, like, when I was younger. I wanted to be a
geologist?
Yeah.
I did have an interest in geology when I was really young.
Like, I have, like, honestly, I have, like, such a rock slash fine gem fetish, yeah. It's kind of, like, I love really nice-looking geodes.
Yeah, geodes are the best, dude.
Yeah, dude, I'm just, like, shit. I get tingles and shit when I look at, like, really well-cut geodes and shit. I'm just like, oh!
Guys, I'm Googling geodes for the rest of the night. All right.
We should go on mining.
No, we should not.
No. Okay.
Instant rejection.
I want to go pick up rocks and gems.
Topaz is also my
Your birth color.
Yeah.
How do I tell what my birthstone is?
What month are you?
Mine's amethyst.
Yeah, what month are you? October?
October is topaz, right?
No, November is topaz.
Oh. I have tourmaline opal.
That one's kind of interesting.
American Gem Society.
That one's
amethyst.
I thought I was some... What?
That's amethyst.
Oh, that's amethyst? What?
I'm amethyst this February.
Oh. No, I have a geode. I have an amethyst geode.
Oh, that's interesting.
I'm amethyst.
Wait, oh, you're showing it on camera? Let me see.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. It looks like a meteor.
Yeah, dude. And that stuff is so cool.
Yeah, it's a little dusty and it's kind of faded. But
I have a cut, like a section of a geode as well. Somewhere.
Yeah, I have an amethyst geode at home.
I'm sure it's amethyst as well.
My dad like actually found this one though. It's kind of cool. It's like really rough, but like there's like legitimate amethyst in it. It's not 100%.
Shit.
Though.
I guess I have to Oshimaho now because I'm opal.
I'm topaz and I wouldn't have one anyway. So
tourmaline. Well, okay, Draco, that means you need a Oshi... Oh, wait, topaz isn't in this group.
Citrine is often used...
Oh, citrine?
...as a replacement for topaz, because topaz is, like, really freaking rare.
Morioka Yu. Go for it, Draco. She's 18 years old.
Hey, her nickname she's legal.
Her nickname is Chan Man. Oh shit! Her charm point is smile and smallness.
I'm not against that.
Oh my god. Her future dream is to be an actress who gives excitement and smiles to a lot of people and wants to have a lot of activities in the future. Okay.
AV. Oh.
God, Draco! Come on, get out of here.
I wonder how many of them are actually, like, it's actually their birthstone or something close to.
I know, right? She was born in July, and then July is like, Ruby or some shit? At least according to...
I don't remember.
To the American Gem Society. who gets to decide this shit? I don't even know. It doesn't make sense. Like, does everyone agree upon that or no? Like, I
about
doubt
what?
It.
Yeah,
like, the American like Gem the Society's founders? Classifications.
Maybe like the little like founders or like the Illuminati part of like the
society. Illuminati of gems.
Yeah,
the they gem Illuminati. Like,
hey, I'm born in May, but my favorite rock or my favorite gem is emerald, so I'm gonna choose emerald. And they're like, okay. And they like.
I don't even think emerald is a birthstone.
No, my birthstone is emerald, isn't it?
Oh.
Yeah, it's May.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
So if you are curious, January is garnet, February is amethyst, March is aquamarine, April is diamond, May is emeraldo, June is pearl alexandrite, July is ruby, August is peridot. Peridot? I don't know.
Peridot.
September, peridot. September is sapphire. October is tourmaline opal. November is topaz citrine. And December is tanzanite zircon turquoise.
Yeah, it was like, yeah, man, we ran out of all the popular... we ran out of all the popular stones. It's just throw, like, really obscure.
Well, what was that? That middle one?
Zircon?
Zircon. Yeah, zircon is used zircon. As a...
Cuba zirconium?
Fake diamond, yeah.
Yeah, fake diamonds. So December's a fake April.
Yeah.
No, I'm just kidding. It's just my color, that's all it is. I just realized that.
Yeah.
But, like, I thought opal was orange, but then there's, like, different variations of opal. Oh, because tourmaline is, like... I'm looking at the Gem Society's pictures, and it's, like, it could be, like, a ruby red, it could be, like... Like a lychee / Coca-Cola. It could be
opals.
A freaking...
can be, like, white.
Yeah, like, it's everything. Dude, yeah. I could be any color I want to be. Get out of here.
The opals are very, like, rainbow-colored.
I'm the color of the rainbow, asshole.
Turquoise is a predominantly blue, but it's got a lot of
green
rainbow-style colors, too,
in
it.
Oh. See, the turquoise on their site is like a light blue egg.
Yeah, that's probably American turquoise.
Just straight up, I am a blue egg.
Yeah, that's probably American turquoise. Turquoise can also be a green.
Pizza Ghost is asking, does Gem have a rose quartz? I do not believe they do.
No.
Oh no, they did. Her name is Asakawa Nana, but she graduated.
Damn. The diamond left.
The diamond left the group. And the sapphire. Man. Holy shit.
Yeah, dude. I wish I was born in August just so I could be a sapphire. Like, no, sapphire's just gorgeous.
We have the much more rare black diamond still in the group, so.
Ooh.
Kumashiro Jurin?
Yeah.
Black diamond. Oh, yeah. Damn.
Black diamonds are just kind of grayish.
Not true black.
Well, it's just like a black king blade is actually just...
black light, or like...
Yeah, it's clearly black light right now. Yeah. It's just it's like a white bulb, probably shaded in gray tint. Yeah, so... Anyway, enough about precious stones. Let's talk about gems.
We already talked about gems.
We talked about gems, right? I really like that PV overall. I like their costumes. The girls look really cute. I like the concept. The outdoor shots were a little washed out, as usual, when it comes to, an outdoorsy, at-the-bay type of shot. I don't know if it's because it was cloudy or something like that, but the contrast between the indoor J.J. Abrams lens flares to the drabness of the outdoor shots wasn't so great. I wasn't down with that. But otherwise, I really like the song. I think Jem has pretty good choreo, or, fun-looking choreo in general, so... I enjoyed that. That's my two cents.
Yeah. Idle Streets always got some pretty good songs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep. They're a street of idols after all.
Well, there's Gem, Supergirls, Cheeky Parade, and then you got the Idle Street West and East groups.
Dude, so the original Diamond member, Uchimura Risa, she is a member of Supergirls.
Well, yeah.
So I guess, I don't know if she left Gem to be in Supergirls or what, but...
Probably.
Yeah. I don't know if she was... I'm trying to find out if she was the former ace of Gem, but it isn't... I don't think she is. She has a Chozetsu color. It's royal blue. What the f... what does that even mean? What's a how do they get to have Chozetsu colors? Oh, wait, no, the other... Yeah, this is stupid. Whatever. I don't know. I don't even know what they're talking about.
Well... Yeah, I don't either.
What? Someone tell me what Chozetsu color is.
Oh, she's rose pink.
Oh.
That Amin.
Huh?
Maishima Ami.
Maishima Ami.
She's rose pink. From Supergirls?
Oh, from Supergirls. Wait, they get... they have Chozetsu colors? Is that what's going on?
I guess, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Jesus. Yeah, hits the image color... Yeah, the member color which hits the image color is called Chozetsu color. For each color is on button, the emblem, and part of the costume.
Absolute color? Is that what it translates to?
I guess.
Well, you know how when you do the call?
Yeah,
it's Chozetsu Kawaii.
Yeah, doesn't that mean absolute?
Chozetsu Kawaii, Fire Opal.
What? Chozetsu Kawaii, Fire Opal.
Yeah, that's how I'll cheer at gem events from now on. Just
go, what the hell is that guy? Chozetsu Kawaii, Black Diamond.
That guy doesn't even know their names, but he knows all their gem colors. What the shit?
He's a different kind of dedicated.
Yeah, I don't know about that. What is Alexandrite? Oh, that's kind of pretty. All right.
Enough about gem tangents.
Yeah.
Yeah. Enough about Apex.
Let's talk about you.
The song we talked about was "Baby Love Me" by Gem. Well, we're gonna talk about Kikkawa You.
So yeah. You didn't use my lead-in,
Soulja Boy. Crank that, Kikkawa.
This isn't Soldier Boy.
This is Wild Strawberry.
And they can't spell.
All one word. In all caps. But Kikkawa You.
I have to say, Kikkawa always has interesting outfits.
Great.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll never forget that one quote Native American tribal outfit.
I'll never forget half of Momira Clover's.
Yo, outfits. This song is tight in like the first 20 seconds.
Oh, look at that Kurokami. Is she gonna try to do a 7-minute ballad again?
God, like, thank
or
God.
Stage play song?
That was like a 15-minute ballad, dude.
Yeah.
Just like, what? Whoa, what the fuck?
Yo, this song is tight as balls.
She's got that, like, semi-indigenous outfit again.
Yeah, it's a
bad. Oh, God, yeah, it's back.
It's better looking than the last.
No, it's not the Indian Punjabi outfit. This one's, like, full Native American.
Yeah, but it... Yeah.
Man, you Chase, you and Dave are, like, getting loud.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, we're getting ridiculous here.
Louder and louder. My ears are, like, painful.
Yeah, no, I noticed Dave was getting louder earlier.
Why is this happening to us?
Because we're getting excited.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right, let's calm down.
I'm going to lower my gain, yeah, just in case.
How do I even lower gain?
So this is okay, from her third album, You the Third Wildflower.
You the Third.
All one word, capital letters.
No, it's not.
Wildflower is.
Oh, Wildflower, okay. You is also capital.
Yeah.
Yo, whoever's producing her now is doing really good.
Yeah, this is really tight.
This is more in line with, like those power ballad anime song singers that I actually really do enjoy a lot.
I'm not 100 on this, but the production sounds really similar to, Uehara Temptation,
okay,
which is the Zed ripoff song, or the Zed Find You ripoff, because this sounds a lot like a Zed song again, too.
Okay.
Or like Zed production. So I'm not 100, but just based on my ears, this might
You're
be
not 100.
This might be produced by the same guy who wrote Uehara Temptation.
Hmm.
She has fake gems on her head.
Oh, yeah.
She's not real gem.
Yeah, and does she have a precious stone? Does she have a Chozette's color?
Shut up.
She's got a Chozette's print there.
Yeah.
That tiger print. Or
oh, God.
Cheetah or whatever.
Leopard?
Yeah, that NMB print.
Not true Numba.
So
Not
many
true,
other
Jen.
Idol groups in this,
Not
in
true
this one
strawberry.
Idol.
Yeah, where's the strawberry? I mean...
Where is the Rurika from Musubism? Oh God, I like almost blanked out on their name.
Yeah, she's.
But yeah, Kikkawa You looks really good with black hair.
Yeah.
And with this hairstyle.
Yeah, she's.
I guess just in general.
This is, like, kind of her comeback, right? Because she hasn't done a song in 4 months. And that was a 15-minute long ballad.
God. She needed a rest, dude. Like, if she was going to perform that live, that was a whole live.
That was half of a live show right there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That is a live show right there. Like, if it's a...
just by itself.
Small one.
Yeah, depending, it very well could be. But
it's the comeback of the You.
I've liked her stuff more since she moved to, I guess, Universal.
Mm-hmm. Records. Me too. Me too.
Than when she was on, that Sunku label.
Yes.
The Sunku label. That up front.
Well, she was on Zetima, but
wait,
still...
when did she move?
I'm not sure.
It was after that Vocalist album.
Oh.
If you remember that, back in, like, 2011, 2012. Let me see. I think it was, like, it was after Darling to Madonna and Vocalist, which was 2012. So it was, like, 3 years ago.
Okay.
I really like this PV. There's so many cuts and transitions.
That's good. It's they made a completely black background work.
Yeah.
And then it's white at the end.
And it's kind of a backhanded compliment, but it's good use of what they do have, at least. Yeah, I like that contrast where, like, it goes from black background and the wild, kind of like the wild outfit into, like, just close that shit.
Wild strawberry.
Yeah, she's a wild strawberry. That is true. Yo, hold up, I didn't save that gem video. Wow, I looked up a bunch of shit after that.
Well, it's in the podcast outline, or it's in the outline, so you can find it.
Yeah. Gotta put that in my idle music playlist. Alright.
So, boys' guess is that this was done by Michi Tomo.
Who did?
I don't know.
Michi Tomo Saito?
No. The name rings a bell, but I can't. He's a composer.
You can't. You just can't.
He composed for Scandal?
Maybe?
Sengoku Groove. In Flavor.
But there are... It was a lot of, like... I mean, I guess it's typical of a soloist,
He composed for Kikkawa You previously.
It's a lot of shots of, kind of, like, zoom in on her doing somewhat dance moves.
No, he... Oh, he did a lot of Up Up Girls.
Ah.
Yeah, he did Going My Way, Mechikyun Summer, Butter Butter, I Love You.
He did,
He did the whole Hashire, first album.
He did Hashire and, Kaito Shoucho?
For Momoklo? Momoiro?
No, try... Wait. No. Yes. That's Hashire, but the other song's not. It's from Mirai Bowl.
Yeah, he did Paspo too. And a bunch of other like pop artists, like Tsuchiana.
Okay. Yeah.
Nonami Takizawa.
All right. So that was Wild Strawberry by Kikkawa You.
Okay, I was right. It is in Naku Shoujo. So yeah, he's done some good stuff.
Yeah, he's... I could say he's probably one of my more favorite idol composers.
He's done Paspo.
Yeah. He did the early Paspo stuff. Like Vivi Natsu. And
Check-In.
And Check-In. Yeah, he did like a lot. He did like 4 or 5 songs off their first album.
He did Rainai Roars from Bitter and Sweet.
It didn't say if he did this song, but I think that's just because it's so recent and hasn't been updated on the wiki. But if he did this song, like, I really hope Kika stays with him, because I really like the direction Kika's going, with the exception of that 17-minute long thing. Ordeal.
Alright. So let's go ahead and move on to NMB48. This is called Must Be Now. It is their new single.
So we were talking about Sayaka. Well, Chase.
A different Sayaka?
Chase said Yamamoto Sayaka.
Looking gosh darn Freudian slips.
Pretty fierce. Well, she's looking pretty fierce. If the video
can
would
she
look.
Drive, though?
I don't know.
She can. She probably can't, but even then, she can still probably drive better than you.
Oh,
my
shit.
Driving's more fierce.
Shots is...
Yeah, that's not what I want to hear. Right. I don't want to ever hear that your driving is fierce.
Yeah, but your car is probably not nearly that cool.
Yeah, this is some hot shit. Freaking a Lambo with the red cabin lights.
Is that a Lamborghini?
Yeah, yes, it is.
Oh, damn.
You can tell by its design.
That's a really stubby nose, actually. I don't remember Lambo's having that short of a front. That's kind of weird.
Yeah, it's one of the more economical ones.
Was that
There was a really big contrast in comments on this single.
There's a freaking lightsaber sound.
Yeah.
The NMB girls all like it. Like, they all say, oh, it's probably one of my most favorite singles, and then people don't like it because it's a 9-member Senbatsu.
Yeah. Only, like, there is so much, like, butthurt over this single.
Well, my, like, Oshi's in it, so I don't care.
I think everyone that's not an Oshi of these 9 members was really butthurt.
Yeah. Basically.
I'm sure. Like, Team M got shafted, right? Because
yeah.
No one from Team M was there.
No TM people in Sundance, yeah. Too.
By the way, my connection to Ustream is really bad right now, yeah. So, I don't know. Like,
oh, boy.
It's too bad. Like, I got a lot of drop frames, but
who's the girl with the brown twin tails? I've never seen her before.
Ishida Yumi. She's my Vietnamese homie.
Oh,
that's why she didn't look full Japanese.
The one with the black and white checkered blazer jacket, right?
What's funny is I couldn't tell. I was all like, yo, how are they going to put all the best dancers in this music video, and one of them is not Watanabe Miyuki? But then I saw Milky, like, the second after I thought that, and I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah, she just doesn't have that most
She doesn't have the
time.
Screen time, yeah. And I know that was a big complaint, and I can understand that, because it's just like, I'm with the Sayaka and the 9 backup dancers, but...
The thing is, I never really have an issue when Yamamoto Sayaka is like, the super main feature, because, like, I think with her talent, she kind of deserves it. Although I know other people who aren't, or who believe in equality, think that...
I think it depends on the song,
more.
Too.
I mean, she got most of the screen time for, what was that, Punkish, too?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I really like that because, like, I thought, like, I think she's, like, super center material, but, you know, whatever. I'm super biased, too. I just think she has the power to carry it,
yeah.
Too.
Yeah.
So I think, therefore, she's rightfully, like, deserving of a lot of the center time.
This is one girl... Sayaka is one girl that moved from an idol group to another idol group and really prospered.
Yeah.
A lot of times they just don't go anywhere, but Sayaka's really taken off.
She hasn't centered an NMB single in about 2 years, I believe. 1 or 2 years, I forgot.
Yeah, but she's always there.
Yeah, well, she's... yeah.
Whereas my Oshi is, like, never there.
Wait, who's your Oshi?
Kinoshita Haruka, or, yeah.
Haruna. Oh, okay.
The one that gets asked if she's going to drink because she looks like she's 30.
20.
Yeah, she looks so mature.
Yeah.
She's, like, 16.
Yamamoto Sayaka's, like, wearing, like, a... almost like a short wedding dress.
Yeah. Not entirely sure about the choice of clothing for the dress versions, but...
Oh, Jesus. Haruna's 17.
Yeah.
Didn't she join when she was, like, 12?
Something like that, yeah.
Likely, yeah. I mean, Shiroma Miru also, right? What a babby.
Yes.
Has NMB been around for 6 years?
Yeah, it's
2012?
That's...
No,
2010, 2011,
something like that.
She couldn't have joined when she was 12, then, if she's 17.
No, she joined NMB when she was 12 years old and still in primary school.
Zoinks!
She was in Zetsumetsu. Oh my god.
They debuted in 2011.
Okay.
Damn.
Junjo U19 and Virginity.
Actually, that's only been 4 years.
Vaja.
Only.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, like, HKT48 has been around for a while now, too, right? So, like, that feels weird. Yeah, HKT48 technically debuted the same year.
Team B2, because Kinoshita was a first-gen member, was October 2010.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
So that means that NMB's been around at least that long.
Okay. Hmm. Oh, yeah, in July of 2010, they announced that they would create a Namba-based sister group. Yeah. And I think HKT... See, back then, like, they wanted to expand really quickly, and they stopped for a while. But HKT was announced officially on May 1st, 2011. So there was at least, yeah, there's at least, like, a year's gap between the two.
Yeah, I remember thinking that they were expanding a little too fast.
Yeah, and then HKT's rise was, you know, mostly due to Sasha Areno.
Yeah, I remember I was like, man, HKT's gonna get shafted so hard. And then they ended up becoming...
They kind of did the first
I mean, they were,
year
until
two,
Sasha,
but...
yeah.
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 Yas. It's like each group, it's like each sister group kind of had its turn, you know? Like, SKT had its moment for a while, then it was NMB, kind of had, like, the forefront, and then HKT had it for a more briefer moment, and now it's just kind of like this weird amalgamation of NMB, HKT, and AKB, I feel. Or am I wrong?
No, what? I'd say that's about right. SKE's just kind of hanging on there.
Yeah, they're hanging for dear life.
Sadly.
Mm-hmm. Got to get them out of the rut. Alright, well, I like this song. It's cool.
Yeah, there's not as much dancing as I thought there should be.
Yeah.
But it's a good song.
Or at least not as much, like, dance showcasing.
Yeah.
Like, there's plenty of dancing, but it wasn't very... It wasn't, like, the main focus of it. There's a lot of signage solo shots and, like, them rotating and walking. Stuff.
Yep. Okay. No egregious lighting shots, though, really.
Yeah.
Unlike normal for AKS.
Mm-hmm. I'm still reserving my judgment on this song. I know that it's really polarizing for some people, or at least the single or the release of it is, but...
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. I can't really... I like the tone that it's trying to set with this kind of, like, high-energy dance, somewhat, like, electro-urban feel to it. But it's, in usual, like, idol fashion, when they try to move into that EDM realm, it, like, shit like that gets really noisy.
Yeah. It gets kind of half-assed at times.
Yeah.
Which is a point that I've brought up before.
And so, that's why I'm reserving my judgment for it. For, like, you know, probably a few more listens.
Kind of reminds me of Ambulance, in a way.
Yeah, like, Ambulance has a really good, like, composition to it. It's just, the way it's arranged really makes it sound like it makes it sound cheaper than it should be.
Mm-hmm.
And
that's I personally thought Ambulance was overhyped, and I think this is a tiny bit overhyped too. I think people feel
that this song is like the best NMB song ever are definitely
let's calm down. Yeah, hell no.
Because Zetsumetsu Kurokami Shoujo is still the best NMB song.
No, obviously, Kitagawa Kenji is the best NMB song.
No, Ha is the best NMB song.
Okay, yeah.
That was never an A-side.
Yeah. Kinjo U19's the best, so.
No,
no, obviously, oh my god, it's the best NMB song.
No, yeah, it's all about Boku Daki no Secret Value.
Oh god. But yeah.
Actually, I really like that song. Like, I didn't think I would like that song, but I really like it now.
Yeah.
Screw Durian Shonen, though.
Oh, gross. Okay. Yeah, but I equate Ambulance a lot with this song, just because I think it's good.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it's amazing, and I think it's overhyped. You know, it's a cool song, but it's not that cool.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. It's like 60% cool.
The car makes it pretty freaking awesome.
Yeah, the car was the coolest
Is it really weird that I think it's, like, stranger for idols to drive than to have boyfriends?
I mean, just because it's foreign, in Japan,
like, fewer people have cars than people have boyfriends. Actually, I don't know if that's true or not. I would think it would be true, because driving is not as important, especially in, you know, the cities. I don't know.
We had the AKB driving club.
Yeah.
Yeah, and guess what they did? They just, Asuka took a test.
I don't know. I actually kept up with that TV show for a while.
I watched all of it.
Yeah. Right?
Yes, it was pretty freaking boring.
Yeah, it was really boring.
God,
it was.
I wanted to see idols drive. No, it was just.
Let's learn about the test. Yeah, it was like these are the different kinds of licenses that you can get stamped on your car.
Though I will say that one of the best parts was when the guy was teaching her hill techniques inside the FRS or the 86.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a diagram that showed how you put your feet on the pedals, and that made me realize that I was somewhat driving a stick wrong, because I would always keep my heel pressed to the floor.
On your clutch?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, no. Oh yeah, I don't do that. Okay, yeah. Cool.
Whereas
you always put your dude that hurts because that makes
yeah
you,
exactly
that makes you fulcrum on your ankle and that's like,
yeah
terrible.
exactly Ooh. And that's bad for your ankle. So then I had to like relearn, like I did it in like a night, but I relearned how to use my clutch pedal only using my thigh.
Yeah, you just
kind of
like
oh
yeah,
my
you,
god the
yeah,
degree
you
of control is so much better.
Yeah, you use your knee as a fulcrum, not
yeah
your ankle.
And I was like, wow, the Jidosha Bu taught me something. It's great. So, and other than that, there's some of the roles that are like Japan specific or whatever that they'll talk about. Mm-hmm. I know that they prefer using the rear gear for when you park rather than first.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
They put into reverse when they park.
Yeah. Well, I mean, both of them work because they're both of them are your largest gears.
Yeah. That's interesting.
Yeah, but I was like, okay, that's cool. Yeah. So. But yeah, that's, anyway, so, Yamato Zaika drives in with a Lamborghini, and it's great. That's the best part of the music
drives
video
in,
you guys.
Drives in with the Lamborghini.
Yeah. She rolls in a Lamborghini.
It might just be like a husk, like
probably,
a Lamborghini
yeah,
husk.
Yeah, it was probably pushed by some dudes.
Well, I mean, you kind of hear the car, and you see it roll in, but
you can add those sound effects.
But you never actually see her behind the wheel.
True.
Until she gets out.
Yeah, like, let's watch that again.
That reminds me of, did you guys see there was this, like, rapper who, like, a humor rapper who made a music video on a $0 budget?
That does not surprise me.
I'm trying to find his name. It was, like, a couple days ago. He's actually pretty good. I listened to the song, it was actually pretty good. It was featuring Fetty Wap and this other guy. And it was, he's like this white Jewish humor comedic rapper, but it's actually like pretty seriously like good beats and music. And he went to a Lambo dealer and was like, hey, I'm this rapper. You might've heard of me. We're trying to shoot a music video where the whole point of it is to not use any money. And can we borrow a Lamborghini for like 15 minutes?
Oh my god.
And the guy let him because he actually recognized him. And like they went to houses in Beverly Hills and they were like,
that is
on
so
the door.
Ridiculous.
Yeah, and this one old lady let him use their house as
like
a setting.
Man, the liability.
Yeah, no, they had forms and stuff. Like everyone like filled
out. Oh wow.
Yeah, it was really well done actually.
But still
cool.
Like, man, what kind of salesman goes, I mean, yeah, I guess you want to use a Lamborghini for a shoot. Here you go.
Well, it's because the salesman recognized him and was, like, a fan of his music and, like,
okay.
Played it.
That's lucky, dude.
Yeah.
Or, like, he found the right salesman, but...
Yeah.
Still, that's so ridiculous.
15 minutes, that's shorter than a test drive.
Yeah, it was a Lil Dicky. Yeah, that's the name of the rapper. And the video is...
You can crash a Lambo in 15 minutes easily.
Yeah, no, it was just kind of rolling down the street, though, because he was doing the thing where, like, he got out of the car.
Was he ghost riding the whip?
Yeah, no, he wasn't on top of the car, but he was, like, running next to it.
And yeah, stuff, no, that's... That's so dumb, God.
Yeah, and they, like, crashed T-Pain's music video set to use that one.
That's great.
It was actually... Yeah, I'll link it later, but it was actually a pretty dang good video. Yeah.
Man, I want to be a... Now I want to go tell people that I'm a semi not famous rapper and go borrow Lambos.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the correlation was it might not have been that hard to rent a Lamborghini.
Oh yeah, of course. But you know the Japanese, they're like, "Well, we have to buy this shit because it's production."
Maybe it's Akimoto's.
They'll buy it and then write it off as a tax deduction.
Yeah. Maybe it's like Akipis or like Kitagawa Kenji's or something, you know.
God, imagine Kitagawa Kenji driving a Lambo.
No, it's probably Yoshimoto's.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Tokusaki's.
Tokusaki.
I don't think he's got that kind of money.
Yeah.
He spends it all on weed, that's why.
Them company... terrible weed, right?
Yeah, weeds really and hoes.
Shitty Japanese weed. Anyway.
Okay. So, Must Be Now by Nimb48. And that's going to do it for the impressions for tonight.
I thought you were going to say Must Be Now time for the news.
Wow. That kind of would have been good, actually.
Now it's time for the news.
But, Anyway, all right, so...
Time for the news.
What are we going to talk about here? Freaking Lady Baby. I know you've heard of them. They're going to be holding a mini concert in Los Angeles, the city that I am living close to.
You going to go see them?
I think so. It's going to be on a Tuesday, though, so letting you know.
Tuesday in, like, 2 weeks.
No podcast on October 13th if I'm going to drive in L.A. after work. So.
Well,
it's taking place at like an anime store.
Yeah, Jungle in Little Tokyo.
Wow.
So
it's perfect.
It says the start time is 7 or doors open at 7 p.m.
Free admission, dude.
Wow. Yeah, dude. Free Lady Baby lot. That's how you do it.
How'd they pay?
Wow.
Though, to be honest, I thought they'd be in demand.
To be honest, I think Lady Baby is so. Here's the thing, like, groups like say Lady Baby and Baby Metal are quote-unquote gimmicky enough for audiences, like, here.
Yeah.
That's why they can do it.
They're also, well, given the
like, Lady Baby's getting a shit... Yeah, they're getting a shit ton of popularity for just being what they are.
So, like, ergo, wouldn't they be in high demand, then? And, like, be pretty expensive?
Well,
Or are they no Baby Metal?
I don't think they'd actually be that high demand, because I don't think they're that popular in Japan.
Yeah, like they're still relatively, I mean, Baby Metal as well is disproportionately more popular outside of Japan than inside.
I guess I just lump Baby Metal and Lady Baby together a lot.
Actually, I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm talking out my ass, because freaking Baby Metal can't fill like every single venue that they go to. Granted, they do a really good job at most of them, but I'm just saying, like, It's hard to find, like, Baby Metal's a really strong niche following outside, whereas they can reach a lot, like, a broader audience, even though it's still a niche. Lady Baby, is still gonna be very much like, oh, LOL Japan type of stuff, but...
Yeah.
It's still, it stands out more than, say, the typical idol, like, Musubism Come in OC Fair.
Or, you know, like, Scandal.
Yeah, even, I mean, Scandal, it's like, oh, look, this all-female rock band from Osaka, and it's like, no, I mean, that doesn't really matter. We have all-female rock bands in America as well, so it's not like a... But do we have freaking pro wrestler with two lolly entourage? No, maybe, yeah. I don't know.
Cross-dressing
pro wrestler from Australia with two Japanese girls.
Yeah, he's got a lot of little titles you could add to that.
What?
He also did stunt work in some Chinese movies.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's actually
vocalist,
amazing.
Vocalist, stuntman, grab your model.
The interviews with him have been pretty sweet. Like, just him talking about his life and how he ended up becoming lady beard of Lady Baby. Mm-hmm. So,
you know, after watching one of his interviews, I actually was like, okay, now I don't feel so bad about laughing my ass off at him.
Yeah, I mean, it's all in good fun, you know?
Yeah, because he's not, like, seriously trying to cross-dress. He's just having fun.
Yeah.
Being different.
So, there's, like, a flyer on, and the link is to the Facebook event, just because there's no, like, I don't really have another... We're looking at, like, facebook.com/LadyBaby2015. So yeah. There's an opening set by DJ Monica Starling. There's a Lady Baby mini concert / talk show. And then there will be a photo opportunity with Lady Baby, free with the purchase of Lady Baby merchandise, as well as a Halloween-themed fashion show.
That's a really cool and really awesome deal.
Yeah, so like, I'm looking not forward to this.
I'm not even, like, a huge fan of Lady Baby, but, like... I think that
I would totally do that. Because, yeah. I mean, well, in general, I like to see, like, groups come here, you know?
This is going to be a super intimate show at a super intimate venue with free admission.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. Get but super intimate with Lady Baby, especially Lady Beard.
But yeah. How much is merchandise going to be?
Probably like
30
15,
bucks, 30 to 50.
No, 30. Yeah, just, I mean, I expect typical idol prices, so. Hey, let's try to get an interview with him.
Yo.
Yeah.
You should probably
do
email
it.
Cherry, Jerry.
Just do it. Yeah. First Dave.
So, this, you know what sucks is Serena, this entire show has been like really, really low volume.
Oh, really?
She also doesn't know how to fix it because she has a shitty Mac.
Sorry. I'm trying to build a computer.
That or she just doesn't know. She doesn't know how to... Like, Chase, how do you do it? Oh, you have a microphone that has gain you can adjust.
Yeah. Also, I don't know why, but my... Like, I don't know, because her system settings, it's like the audio auto-adjusts.
Oh, yeah. It's yours doesn't?
No.
Mine used to. I don't know how I made it stop.
All right, so I need to go use the restroom, so... Please continue talking about either Lady Baby or move on to the next discussion topic.
I think we said all that needs to be said about Lady Baby. I guess, if you're in the area...
Or in New York. Performing in New York.
Yeah. When is that show? Is it not confirmed
October
yet?
October 11, I believe.
Okay,
it's
so...
It's like an actual show with paid admission.
Is that Hammerstein Ballroom? You know?
I forgot.
Alright.
It's on their official Facebook page, and they also have a YouTube video for it.
Okay. So, they're gonna be in New York on October 11th, and then 2 days afterwards, they're gonna be in LA for a free show at Anime Jungle on the 13th. So, if you wanna go see Lady Baby, that is your chance. Oh, it's SOB's club, downtown Manhattan.
Yes.
Never heard of that venue. All right, that's cool.
Wonder if that's going to be like 21 plus only or something.
Possibly.
Admission's not bad. It's $15.
There was a group that was in New York and LA that I wanted to go see. Oh God, 5-6 years ago.
Which group?
Headphone Presidents. And they were playing only at 21 plus clubs.
And you were like 20 at the time?
No, I was 21, but I couldn't afford it.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Because you have to transport.
Yeah. I got to change from a regional to a national airport, and it costs $600 to fly anywhere.
You poor soul, man. You can't go to anything.
Yeah, pretty much.
All right. Okay. So, next up. You want to skip this one until Dave comes back, because we're probably gonna...
I'm already sick.
Okay. Well, we're all done with Baby Metal. We were going to move on to the court justice ruling on the female idol who broke the no dating rule.
Oh, wait, so you talked about the Baby Metal and Skrillex?
No.
No, that's the last one.
You meant Lady Baby.
Yeah. God, Chase, come on.
That wasn't even my fault!
You
said Baby
said
Metal, by the way. That's why I was confused.
Oh.
All right, fuck. So let's talk.
It's the same thing.
It was your fault.
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
Same difference.
Chase, you piece of shit. You're just salty because you didn't get to see them live.
Same difference. I can't say that on air.
All right, so...
So, yeah.
Let's talk about this.
So...
Go for it, Draco.
Well, do we know who it was? That's the question.
Internet detectives.
Two channel.
They hypothesized that it's... that's... Or the... At the time... the 17-year-old member of Doki Doki that debuted in July 2013 and then disbanded December 2015.
Wow.
So they only lasted a couple months.
Okay. Because I know of another one who sued an idol because of dating.
But yeah, this is like the first successful management versus idol suing, I believe.
Wait, so this one's not Aoyama Saint Hachimecha High School?
No, because Aoyama Saint Hachimecha High School is still together.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, this one...
Yeah, I was like, wait, we covered them. Okay.
Yeah, this one's different.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, so do you want to actually say what happened?
Well, the courts ruled that she has to pay 650,000 yen... about $5,500 in compensation to her management company for being in a relationship with a boy.
Oh man, that exchange rate.
Yeah. Basically the ruling wasn't exactly because she was dating, it was because the group ended up disbanding and the it became impossible for the company to recover its initial investment. And the defense was like pretty freaking weak on her part. The girl's side argued, for idols it is not indispensable that they do not associate with members of the opposite sex. That seems pretty weak, but at the same time, you know, that was apparently one of the rules that they could not associate with members of the opposite sex.
Uh-huh.
And, I don't... I mean, that's a very broad statement. Or a very broad...
Associating with... Members of the opposite gender?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean...
Yeah, associating is like, oh, hey, let's go do homework together at Starbucks. You've been caught red-handed! By all your classmates!
Going out with your manager.
That's Daijoubu.
But it's still a member of the opposite sex.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
In a lot of cases.
What if you hang out with your dad? He's
going out with my female manager.
Asshole. Yeah. So,
Oshima Yuko dating her dad.
If the actual terminology in the contract was that she can't, or they couldn't associate with the opposite sex, then that means they could associate with the same sex,
which
also includes a possibility of dating someone in the same sex, which is still like an investment disadvantage.
Yeah, it's still... according to this article, which, you know, without knowing the exact wording used from the Japanese, it also says a prohibition on dating a boyfriend and taking photos as a couple. It says nothing about dating a girlfriend or... So, yeah, there is that.
But, wow.
Yeah, the idol group consisted of six members, made its debut in October 2013. However, her association with a member of the opposite sex was revealed, and the group disbanded the same month.
It was revealed that she saw the fam when she was like 15 or something, too.
Oh, like she started seeing him when she was 15?
she saw him when she was 15, yeah, and then she was, and then it came out when she was 17, and no one's even like really bothering to even mention that.
Damn.
Or like that's not the main focus of the issue even.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I mean because like there's the whole deal that like, hey, this is enforced by a legally binding contract.
So,
and then there's the whole, like, the international reaction to it, of course, is going to be way different than most, or at least it's going to be fairly different from the Japanese reaction to it.
Yeah, I don't know. What you mean in the sense that international fans are like, let the girl be who she wants to be, let her date who she wants to date.
Somewhat, but I'm talking, like, if there's going to be, I'm sure there already is, media coverage of it. Is going to skew heavily towards, like, this is a human rights violation or something like that.
Yeah, Hollywood Reporter made an article on it, and it was pretty gross.
So, if she started dating this person when she was 15, was she still dating him?
No, she was photographed coming out of a hotel with him at 15.
Okay, but was she still dating him at 17?
Nobody knows.
Of course, but I guess it's from 2000. I guess this did happen in 2013, so...
It was just a verdict wasn't passed until recently. It was just kind of idling in court.
Yeah, okay. So, yeah, I guess she would have been 15 at the time.
Yeah.
But they were suing her for 5.1 million yen.
Oof. Let's be glad it got reduced for her.
Yeah,
I mean, it's for loss of venture or business capital or potential earnings.
Yeah.
If I can throw out my two cents, I think that it's pretty justified. If only for the fact that, you know, it's like it's a business contract.
Yeah. And
business contracts have violated way worse than like than who you're allowed to date.
Yeah.
I guess in that sense, and so like if disregarding the fact that you're an idol, because this is a job, if you're in a business to work, you need to be abiding by the contract that's set down.
Yeah, and she was informed, you know, at the signing of what the rules entailed, so.
Yeah.
You know, it is a blatant disregard for the contract that she signed.
Well, I mean, we've talked about this shit, like, at length before, you know,
we don't have to get into it too heavy.
And stuff like that. It is really tricky because, from, like, a moral standpoint, I do think this is some, if not gray water, fairly not so cool territory to ever venture in because, like, realistically, I mean, I get it. I understand the desire for the idol image to be a certain way. But like, you know, I feel like it's at the expense of the employees when has it come to something like that.
Yeah. Well, then the industry, then if there's really an issue, then the industry needs to have a whole upheaval and change.
And that kind of leads into like the whole idea of the entertainment industry. Because, you know, every now and then stuff resurfaces about, major pop stars who have experienced abuse and stuff like that. And I mean, Chase, you're the one who told me that like Kesha's manager was like sexually abusing her and stuff like that too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's like, holy shit, you know, you would have thought that in this day and age that wouldn't be as prominent, but who knows, like it still could be rampant amongst music pop stars here in America and Hollywood as well.
Yeah.
So... And then the assumption is that because Asia and Japan, I guess specifically in this case, is more patriarchal and even more secretive about stuff like this. Like, you know, you don't know what's going on behind closed doors as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some of the stuff that the judge said was kind of off-putting, too, in the ruling. Because one of his quotes was, the revelation of an idol's association with a member of the opposite sex worsens the image of the idol. And then later on, another quote is, as long as she was a female idol, a prohibition on dating was necessary to obtain support from male fans.
Yeah, that's where I'm just like, man, I can't stand, like, I get the reasoning behind it, but I'm just like, you know, this is not, this should not be in legal grounds.
Yeah, personally, I'm against it, but it's like, if, like, business-wise, yeah, I mean, you signed it, so.
Yeah.
It just sounds like a sham of a legal proceeding in general when...
Yeah.
When the basis is her, like personal relationship got in the way of an investment, and then it's like, oh, well, we can prove that because, or my ruling is that, yes, that, you know, her personal relationship ruined the venture capital / investment because her image needed to be a certain way for a certain audience of this market. But, I don't know. Freaking! It just seems like, I don't know. Is the judge a closet idol fan? Like,
well, you know, that's kind of the thing. It says that a prohibition on dating was necessary to obtain support from the male fans. Well, we can prove that that's not right because we got Sasha and Minagishi.
Of course, yeah. Their management decided not to sue them, though.
Or fire them.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's so, too much money to be had.
Yeah, obviously, this unnamed idol's management group decided that she was worth a lot.
Well,
or, I mean, that. Or, yeah.
She was worth more being disposed of completely than, you know, trying to save.
Well, I think. Well, also, it said the idol group broke up because word of her. Ludax got out.
Oh, that's freaking terrible. I mean...
Yeah, so it was like, this is on you, so you have to pay.
That's the thing, like, saying it's all because it's all her fault is really shitty, too.
Well, apparently it was her... Well, apparently it was her fault, that's why.
No, but I so what are the circumstances behind that, though?
Like, the fan... Like, word and pictures got out, and the fans found out, and the girls found out, so then, like...
So, I guess to me... What that sounds like is the other members got pissed off. And they're like, we're not going to do this group anymore if you're going to keep doing this shit. So then they walk. And then that means the group disbands. Like, if it's that, if that's the case, and like... I mean, that's still a personal issue, though. Like, the girls... The girls don't have any legally binding contracts with the other girl to say, like, if you do this shit, then we're going to walk, obviously.
Yeah.
That's an emotional decision. Of course, the contract itself says you can't be associated with a boy or with a male.
No,
so that's grounds for termination.
Opposite sex. So that includes females or males, depending on it. What, you know?
Oh, what her gen? What her?
Well, what the member makeup of the group is, whether there's male and female members.
Oh, or not. I was just assuming it was an all-female group.
Yeah.
I don't know. It doesn't say in this.
Well, we can usually assume because most other groups are. Yeah.
Yeah, unless you dream five. Or, you know.
Then you're living the dream five.
That other group. That other group that spawned off of Kadi.
Oh.
Tempura Kids?
Yeah.
Wait, Tempura Kids have dudes in it?
It has one guy.
Yeah.
I couldn't P-chan. Tell.
P-chan is a male.
What? Tempura.
Gotta
look like it how up.
That's like the one thing Serena says, like, Tempura Kids? It's like, oh shit, showstopper. Oh,
yeah.
He's the top search result for Tempura Kids.
Yeah.
P-Star Chan.
He's like the smallest member too. Or was.
Yeah, was.
Man, I could not tell.
No.
It's a trap.
Anyway, I feel like there's not that much information out.
Besides. No.
All it is like the result. And
yeah. The only reason I knew some of the stuff that wasn't noted in that article is because I read some translations of like the... Like, some Japanese, threads and articles on it. So.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Imagine if, like, because she got caught, the other members were like, oh shit. And then like management hired private investigators to tail the other members and found out that the rest of the members had associations with the opposite sex too. So then they all disbanded.
But I wouldn't think they would have enough money to do that.
Yeah. But like, I'm just saying,
like, that's too much effort. That's too much effort to go through. Like, if you, as management of an idol company, especially if you're on a tight budget and you find out that one of your members is dating someone, your best bet is to just be like, listen, like, you can still make money for us. You just gotta hide that shit. Because if anyone finds out, we're screwed. That's pretty much it.
You know, that's really the truth of it, too, because the settlement was, you know, $5,500. They probably spent more than that suing her.
Yeah, like,
I mean,
that's chump change in terms of, like, any sort of legal battle for, especially for the entertainment industry. You know, this was really, like, the little leagues.
Yeah, this was, like,
that was honestly a small settlement.
Yeah. I mean,
considering they were gunning for $5 million. I mean, but even then, $5 million.
They're going to spend, what, half of that just in court fees and lawyers and everything else?
Maybe the setup wasn't even that elaborate, and, the girl chose to represent herself, and then the agency chose to represent themselves. And then,
I guess I wouldn't be surprised.
I mean, I didn't really think the agency had that great of a lawyer, considering it took, 2 years to prosecute properly.
Oh, my God. Wow.
That's court rulings for you. Some of them take forever.
Yeah. Alright. I think we said enough on it.
Did we really?
Nah. Yeah. Let's keep going. Alright.
I mean, I don't know. My only thoughts are that I'm okay. Like, I'm honestly okay with the trend of say trying to be more progressive, where the idol industry doesn't need to be a very locked down type of female worshipping thing. Yeah. Even though that is like the definition of idolatry, yeah, right?
By all means,
I understand the tact in such a procedure though, because, so, I guess an example to borrow from is K-pop stars not necessarily contractually obligated / regulated by the law to not be seen going out with, members of the opposite sex, but it's highly encouraged that they don't. If you're in the entertainment industry, this is especially more if you made it big, you can always do stuff in your private life, completely in private.
Yeah.
Just look at that goddamn resort / karaoke bar hotel that Mod Osco went to. Like, Jesus Christ. Did Oda Pro pay for that? Because, damn, dude.
But, shit's high scale.
Yeah, there's plenty of shit like that. And in Japan especially, there's a lot more emphasis on, the need for privacy in a third-party place because, the home does not serve as that very well. Yeah. So, I mean, I feel like, a part of me is this is really shitty. This is not a trend that should continue where, management companies already have enough power over their talent. They don't need to be, I don't need more court cases where they're suing their own talent, former talent, for damages based on just personal life choices. But it's a two-way street. The management company does a lot for you, so as their employee, you're expected to be a certain way. So this is an extreme, but on our side, right? Most of us, if we work for any sort of reputable company that has a really good brand or something like that, and our social media accounts are found out, and all it is shit talk about the brand or something that would make it seem more distasteful, then we'd have a talking to for that, or we'd be terminated for something like that.
Yep.
The whole whatever you put on the internet is no longer private is true. and, you know, it's only made the world smaller, whereas in these cases, it just seems like the internet makes it so that you can, unfortunately, stalk people easier, but it's still an old-school tactic of like, hey, I got caught with someone, and they took photos, like, shit. Sell that to a newspaper, you're done. Put it on Twitter. It's just a faster route.
But, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's a difficult situation, because obviously I don't want to be near the realm of human rights violations, but at the same time, there are regulations put into place that state that, like, relationships between certain people shouldn't be happening because it is the workplace after all.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. So, that's it for me.
Great.
I don't know if you have any other comments, guys.
I said what I wanted to say.
Okay. Nah.
Serena, you're the lone representative of the XX chromosome spectrum. What are your thoughts?
I mean, well, although I think, I think it's fine. I don't know if it really violates human rights. Then I would I would think of it as like, oh, I wouldn't, because if I was offered a job and then my, like, one of the contract rules was, oh, I can't associate with the opposite sex, then it would be, is the job really worth it? And since she signed it, she thought that the job was worth giving up relations with guys, yet she broke it. So I think it's fair, and I think it's justified. I think the suing is a little bit, I wouldn't have expected it, but at the same time, I think their suing is somewhat justifiable because, you know, they already invested and they already put money out, but you broke contract and made it so that the company couldn't make money. But then I thought it was kind of dumb how, not dumb, but tired, like frustrating how they put so much effort into suing this girl when they could have just been investing in someone else that would have made them more money.
Maybe, but the group disbanded, remember, so they can't make any money.
Yeah, which I'm saying, like, oh, they might as well make a new group, but then if they don't have money, then they have to sue her, which is
not, which still sounds stupid, like Draco said, because don't you have to spend a lot of money in order to, like, take them to litigation? Unless, like, for some reason there's, like, public defenders who are willing to do this shit, like, pro bono over there. I don't think we have as much knowledge of the Japanese legal system as we think we do, so.
Oh, I know we don't. But, I mean, yeah, it just seems, it seems excessive to sue them.
When did I cut myself?
I know, I cut my thumb, too, and I don't know how.
I just have, I all of a sudden have this cut on my middle finger, and I'm like, the shit.
So. Moving on.
All right. In lighter news, Draco, what is this?
I don't know.
Okay.
Oh, this one. Oh, this was mine. I was just looking at the other one. Mutotomu Tanayuka, Oshimaroka, and Takashi Judy are doing the theme song for Fuyu Shupo, which is a... It's a sports campaign, merchandise campaign. They're doing the theme song for it. It's supposed to be, like, one of the largest sales of sporting goods in Japan, apparently. Mm. And the title of the song is Hajimaru no Yuki, so the start of winter.
So why choose these certain members?
I don't know. That's a very good question.
Maybe Tanayuka, because she has abs. And she's very...
It's all about the abs.
That's a very good question. I don't know.
These ladies are somewhat the future, but the mid-tier future. So, so like,
that's very true.
They are the future, but they will be surpassed by other members very soon.
Yeah.
God, I hate taking a crap on these, like, on what you called, like, the mid-tier future. Mm-hmm. But, like, they look, like, I can't tell them apart, honestly.
Damn, that's because you're terrible. You're
look
bad.
At the, look at the picture in the
you're
banner.
You're a bad fan.
Look at the picture in the banner.
I can tell every single one of them apart.
That's because you're hardcore. But
they're
like,
extremely I am casual.
Okay, but like, so if you're a new fan or even just like a casual, you could usually tell like the
you
old
can say
guard
that,
apart.
You can say that about any Japanese girl group.
Okay.
Let me just make
my point before you disagree with it.
Okay.
Like old Kami 7, you could pretty easily tell them even just by their hairstyles apart.
Yeah, I
could barely tell these four from their hairstyles apart. You know.
How do you get to that point? And this is the riddle everyone's been trying to solve this entire time. Like, AKS clearly hasn't gotten it down. The fans clearly haven't gotten it down. I don't even know if Donald Trump could get this down or whatever, right?
He probably wouldn't. He just tried to build a wall to keep him out.
Yeah, we'll build a wall so that the new members can't make it in to Kami 7.
Yeah.
But, like, okay, seriously, like, I mean, yes, you say, like, oh, you know, hairstyles are all the same or whatever, right? Like, if you just look, okay, Muto Tomun and Tanoyuka, maybe. They both sport the long hair. Takashi Juri's length, not like that, and it's got curls in it, or waves in it. Oshima Ryoka, completely straight. I mean, like, there are already distinct differences between them in that sense. And we're not even looking at their faces yet. Tanoyuka is a really unique-looking person.
She's got a
really
pointy
girl.
Chin.
Yeah.
I think she grew up really well. I really like how she... I really like how she looks now.
She grew it really well.
Grew out. She grew up really well.
Like, cause she, like every day I stroke my chin hoping that it narrows.
You know.
But, yeah, like
I have her chin kind of.
I actually feel the same way as Kenny. I can't tell like a seven member K-pop group apart from each other.
Yeah.
Well, I still have
this because Koreans all right, look alike.
They all have the same plastic surgeon. That's what I've said.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which is really mean, but at the same time, I think that might be true.
It holds some grain of truth, but you know.
Because like, I've followed Girls' Generation, you know, for a while now, and I still can't tell some of them apart, or like I can't like I'll mix the two up, and it's like this is terrible. But I don't know if it's like just the familiarity thing. Like maybe you know, mid-tier / future members of 48 Group just have never received the same exposure as former Kami 7. Or what?
I mean, there's too many factors to tell, but just based on looks, it's like, well, you know, coming in as a completely fresh, unexperienced idol fan, like, I got Yuko and Takamina mixed up, but at least I could at least I could tell Mariko apart, you know?
Wow.
From the
well,
rest.
that's Mariko
because
was,
she was, like,
extremely
distinctive.
Unique, too.
Yeah, distinctive. Yeah. I don't see a whole lot of distinctive in the middle tier. But
well, at least
there's
tell,
too many factors. Maybe that's just because like none of them have unique hairstyles or whatever.
You
know?
Can tell Kinoshita Momoka from everyone else, but
well, yeah.
She doesn't get screen time.
Yeah.
Shit. But anyway, this was they're doing this for some show, so
well, it's supposed to be a sporting goods.
Oh, sporting goods?
Same. Ah.
Dickies.
A sale? Like, this song is just for a sale?
Yeah, I mean, it's like... Yeah. Sportsman's Warehouse is having a sale. They're doing the theme song for it. last year, they sold... Fuyu Shupo saw over 460,000 customers last year.
Dang.
So, you know... There's some possibility there, I guess, for him, but...
That's interesting, and I encourage anyone who does go to Japan in the near future to go to a store called Yodobashi. It is an all-purpose / electronics store. Normally like 7 floors worth of just goodies that a lot of geeks would like. But they have a theme song, and it plays every night, especially before closing. So, I mean, store themes and stuff like that are still... they're still in over there in Japan. So if you want to travel back in time for a couple decades or something? I don't know. Like, go to Japan and see some of the crazy shit they have over there.
Mm-hmm. Some of their models are pretty cute.
I feel bad saying that, too, because it's like, crazy Japan, and I'm trying to... like, we're trying to break that stereotype, but...
But
the theme songs are so good.
Yeah, there's Muto Tomu's also hinted that they'll be appearing at some of the locations during the course of the campaign.
Oh man, so. It's time to buy some sporting goods. You know what sucks though? It's like it's very clear that the idols are basically just like extremely strong like magnet advertising units, and the people who buy the stuff for the idols, like aren't really even gonna use those products.
Yeah,
and it's like. Like, come on, you know? Just that capitalistic waste. So good.
I'm just kind of happy that, like, two of my favorites have managed to be in something that might get them.
Hey, man, it's a step. Keep taking the steps up the ladder of promotion.
Considering that, Tano got shit on during the junkin'.
Yeah. Hey, Anya got shit on during the Jonkin. You lost, like... Come on, yeah, just went down.
Oh, wait, did we talk about the Jonkin?
Not yet.
Not yet.
I mean, the international response was pretty underwhelming. I was expecting people to be all nuts over everything.
That's because this year...
I got, like, 10 tweets.
That's because this year you couldn't cry... Well, you still could, never mind. You couldn't cry about...
No, I didn't see anything from... people like
I saw it all.
I was gonna say NSK was tweeting all night.
I mean, like, as far as like uproar goes, you know, it's like when Paru won, I saw like tweets for days. Who the fuck won last year?
People were all mad and they're like, oh, Jurina? Shit.
Oh no,
yeah, when Jurina won, it was like, this is rigged. This is rigged, and then this year it's like, who the hell won? It was like, it wasn't rigged. Yeah, it wasn't rigged after all, you know?
No, like, but then, like, no, I like the comments that were like, well, obviously they would make it look not rigged because it's rigged.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, God damn it.
You're not.
Do you enjoy your circular logic?
Do we want to get into this now, or finish?
No, let's not talk. I don't want to talk about Jonkin anymore, because we've talked way too much about idols, sex, and judges, and Judge Jiro,
and Drake
making his sushi, and then every time someone, like, yells at his court, he sends them out. I typed it in chat, like, they should, like, someone said they need Judge Judy in Japan, and I was like, it'll be Judge Jiro, but it'll be Jiro who, the sushi chef.
And he just, like, whack him over the head.
He makes sushi with, like, inside gavel. The courtroom, and every now and then he'll just say something, and then someone gets fined money, and that's it. Like, that's,
Jiro dreams of court rulings and sushi.
Yeah, it'll be great.
Yeah, I got a lot of those comments, too, of, you know, it was rigged to not look rigged, but then I looked at who managed to get top 15.
Still pretty rigged.
And
what? Have you seen the Senbatsu chase?
Okay, never mind. It's not that rigged.
Yeah, have you seen?
I know,
it's because
Murashige's
not there, right?
Nah, that would prove that it isn't rigged.
Yeah, no, exactly. If she was in there, then you're like, it's not rigged, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whatever.
You're just as dumb as.
Whatever.
Yeah. All what right, were you saying, so... Serena?
I forgot. I don't know. I just said, like, what did I say? I don't remember.
I don't know. You got
Chase messed me up. I blame Chase.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, you've got, like, Peace and Yokoyama Yui are there for the top 8.
Oh, rigged.
That's it.
That's You know, it's rigged, man. When Senbatsu makes it in the Senbatsu, mm-mm.
And for the top 16, you got, like, Jonishi Kei and Watanabe Miyuki.
Oh, yeah, Miyuki slipped in there.
Yeah, she's, like,
blast. She's, like, 16.
Yeah. Which is funny.
So she's still going to get more screen time than number 3.
Well, maybe, because number 3 and number 4 were Peace and Nishinomeki.
Oh, shit.
Oh. Okay, number 5, then.
Yeah, I'm not sure who number 5 would have been. Like, Augusta Moe or Miyabi, you know?
I got some Moe, yeah.
Girls, I do not know.
She'll get more screen time than the teammate member, at least.
Or yo, the team I got
drafty.
Freaking.
I mean, Watanabe Miyuki made number 9.
You know, Narzake was like, yo, Moe's entrance was straight up racist. I watched it. And, yeah, they got 2 black guys to, like, dress up as prisoners. So I was like,
what?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Like LA prisoners, because they had, like, the orange jumpsuits and everything. I was like,
Wait, did she have a whip or something?
No, but she was like, all like, oh, I'm jumpsuit. I'm like, I'm hood like that. I was like,
I'm hood. Yeah.
that
was basically it.
We're the hood with the hood with the hood. And then.
She's not hood.
That shit's hilarious.
Yeah, it should have been her entrance song, like her walk on. Like
Moe was all thug life, you know, 2 big black shaped heads.
Man, I hope someone gifed that moment.
Dude, you can go. Yeah, probably.
I have to go
actually.
Check Tumblr or something.
Yeah,
I liked Tana's because she came in all hunched over with her arms over her stomach, and then she just. Pops out,
yeah,
and they keep covering her stomach.
Was so good.
Jesus, the costume. I think most of the costumes were better this year than last year.
I
like
I
felt like it was more. I mean, I definitely felt like last year, the excitement was lacking because it was like, oh, these costumes are tame. This year it was just like, let's just do some funny shit. Like I really like the Kojima battle.
Yeah,
where Kojima Haruna strikes. Like the Kojima name off of Mako and Natsuki.
Yeah,
I was like, god damn it. Like, it's so dumb and silly, but like that's so fitting.
Yeah.
I liked Nagisa's watermelon costume.
Oh yeah, that was
pretty
good.
She had a watermelon helmet. It was amazing.
No, I never got that.
Right.
I think it's because she likes watermelon.
Yeah, dude. I'll chill with her, dude. I should go meet her at a handshake and be like, I love Sleeka too.
I like the, I mean, I can't say for sure, but it looks pretty sponsored when, like, 3 of them came out with, like, a mascot.
Oh, yeah. Like Mayu
and Rain.
What's he called? Purin?
Something like Purin?
Yeah,
and dog. I definitely didn't like Mayu's outfit, though. It was just straight up like, oh, no, you're doing,
she
like...
She looked like scrambled eggs.
You look chubby. It's the materials, like, that gross fuzziness that bunches up when you wipe it. It's just, yeah.
I'm not sure I liked Isohara's outfit.
What was hers?
It she was in, like, the rubber with the giant red heart.
No.
I liked Takamina as TMR. That shit was hilarious.
That was hilarious. That was great.
Too bad she lost, though.
Yeah. Well, she won, and then she was gonna go up against Yamamoto for a rematch, but Yamamoto lost. I was just like, wow, why'd you lose? Oh, I liked the fact that Yamamoto and Yuihan were dressed as, like, in traditional yukata. Well, Yuihan was, like, straight up mob boss status.
Yeah.
I like the Okada Nana's. It was, like, because she's super Majime, she cosplayed as a Shibuya, like, Gyaru.
Oh, yeah.
She did the Pada Pada dance.
Yeah, and they're like, oh, that's, like,
that was one of my favorites.
As expected of Majime, like, she would, you know, she has the dance down and everything, too.
She has the dance down 100%.
Yeah. And Peace did her like, her Super Sentai entrance.
Yeah. That was great.
And then
great.
She kicked some nogis or something.
Yeah, dude, I like the... Who was it that just came out, like... A lot of them came out in, like, a bikini or something, right? But then, like, you could overhear Sayane going, opai, opai. This is freaking hilarious.
Uh-huh.
I found Nishino Miki's to be funny. She, like, popped in as
one of she came as a, like...
balloon that you, like, sit in and bounce around in.
And then she jumped out of it, and it looked like she had a cape for the longest time.
Yeah.
Because she couldn't take the whole thing off. It was, like, stuck at her neck.
She's such a spaz, though. Holy shit.
I love the fact that the balloon caught on your foot, and she had to, like, hop 6 feet down the runway before it came off.
Yeah. Get out of here. Okay.
Good times.
Last piece of news.
Alright. Come on.
Do it, Chase.
I like when you put down for Jonkin in the notes.
Jonkin's always rigged, am I right?
Yeah. Alright, so last news. So, as some of you may know, Ultra Japan happened, I think, this past weekend, which is basically just a giant EDM music festival. And they have their Japan route, and Skrillex was the closing headliner for the last day. And he had the surprise guest of Baby Metal.
That's so crazy.
Yeah, it was really weird. And so, Skrillex used to be in like a metal band. So like people were like bringing back his roots or whatever. And so he came up, he played Gimme Chocolate, and then he dropped it into like a new edit of Gimme Chocolate that he made just for the festival. It's pretty cool. There's a I'll link the article in chat. And there's a video of the performance. It's pretty cool. The crowd seemed to receive them well, even though they're not there to see or hear Baby Metal, but it seems that they're pretty popular outside the genre too.
That's good to hear. I mean, I still feel like they're an attractive enough novelty that it's like, oh yeah, that's, you know, I'm down with that.
Yeah. So, I mean, Skrillex really likes them, so, you know.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I like how Billboard described the reaction to Gimme Chocolate. It's like, Skrillex joined them for a crushing rendition of their hit single Gimme Chocolate that sent the crowd at Tokyo Odaiba Ultra Park into conniptions. That makes it sound like they're all having seizures.
Yeah.
That's an interesting way to word it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
Indeed.
All right. So that's going to do it for the news for tonight. This was the NSK Podcast, episode 257. Our Twitter links will be in the show notes. We are at NewSchoolKaidan. I am at Tadave. Draco's at Draco60. Chase is at SarLamsFPG. And Serena is at SerenaLam. Follow us for updates on when we go live and on our usual idol lives in general. You can download our podcast at NewSchoolKaidan.com as well as iTunes or your favorite podcast app such as Stitcher. And if you rate our podcast, that would help us gain some visibility. Also, check out BSGS, BKHGS, The TV on Fridays at 7 p.m. Pacific Time, as well as selective-hearing.com for Asian pop, urban beats, and house music, and nihongogo.com, a Japan online entertainment website. If you're watching this on the YouTubes, give us a like, share it, favorite, subscribe to the channel. Let us know what you want to see from us. And if you want to contribute, go to newschoolkaidan.com/contribute. We could always use fresh meat when it comes to writing, editing, corresponding, translating, graphic designing, even podcasting. If you want to talk about idols in official manner, like here Tuesday nights, somewhat 9 p.m. Pacific time. All right, final word. So I'm all over the place here. But I'll just start it off because
are all those things in the final word yours?
Yeah, it's freaking ridiculous.
Jesus, dude.
Remember I told you about Rock and Roll Widow by E-Girls last week?
Briefly.
I knew it was a cover of a song, but I just found out today that it's a cover of Yamaguchi Momoi. It's considered one of like the classic idols of her time. Apparently she's the one who did the like, well, when I leave the like the leaving of the industry or ending of career ceremony where she like sets the mic down or whatever. Like Takashi Minami stated in one of the AKB documentaries that she wanted to be like Yamaguchi and set the mic down and just be like, that's it, it's done. But yeah, I was surprised. I looked it up on YouTube, and I was like, oh, I'm going to watch this.
Yeah, there are a bunch of... All these CMs.
There's this one... there's this one video where it's like a jam session. It's like more in the present, so she's like a lot older now, but it's like a jam session between like different artists or like instrument players, and then she's singing the vocals, and I was like, oh wow, look at that. Scandal did a cover of that song as well, and I watched that, and then I found out that this song was used for a commercial for Kose. For their eye makeup line, Addiction, and I have some. I'll put some links in the show notes of the e-girls commercials. Like it's awkward when it's like a minute and a half long because they just pose for a really long time, but when it's more of a like 20-second spot, it makes more sense. Mm-hmm. Also, you know, Bird Girl Washio is in there, so I'm down with that. Not what I expected the song's image to be, though. But that's just me and my interpretation of E-Girls' album. And so what was interesting was last week Tron messaged me and was like, yo, did a lot of people tune in last week? Because the podcast has like over 1,000 views.
What?
And I was like, what? Like the latest podcast we did had over 1,000 views. And so I looked it up, and apparently the Little Glee Monster video that I took at J-Pop Summit got like picked up by some, probably on 2chan or something. It's more than 20,000. Like I think it's gonna hit 30,000 soon.
It's at 30,000.
It's at 30,000 now. Great.
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of people are just like commenting about how they, you know, they either like Little Glee Monster or like, oh, like of course they would do covers if they're in America, yada yada.
Oh yeah,
I was like, holy shit.
We got the Japanese comment section going on the videos. Yeah. Now.
I just feel bad because the festive video has no one looking at it.
It's got like
30. I'm just like, God damn it. So, but that's cool. I mean, if they wanted to check out some Little Glee and then be like, what's this channel about? And be like, nope, it's just weeboos. Exit. Like, whatever. Thanks.
1,038 views.
But it just goes to show that, like, hey, man, share the stuff wherever you can. And if it's valuable to you, it might be valuable to someone else. So... and last and definitely least is, I guess I didn't talk about this in Ketchup, but I bought these zinc keycaps for my keyboard, but they only come in like a 37-piece set. So they cover all the letters of the alphabet, some punctuation, and the arrow keys. And it's interesting because I bought both the silver and the gold sets. I'm not gonna lie, I kinda don't like them.
Wait, the rose gold ones that you have?
No, the ones I have on my keyboard right now are silver.
Oh.
I have a picture of the
gold
ones.
They look
kinda
rose goldy.
Yeah, there's a lot of warmth. Like, the light in my room is really warm, so they look kinda goldy. By the way, rose gold is an excellent color.
Yeah, I know, that's why...
The new iPhone, Chase, get it.
Yeah.
But anyway,
the price is killing me.
Yeah. What I don't like is that they're completely smooth, and because they
you don't have markers? You don't have finger markers?
Oh, yeah, they don't have, like, the home row?
F and J?
Yeah, there's no little
risen
pieces to indicate that that's home row index. And then the other thing is, this is just, like, I mean, this is going to be obvious, but these keycaps feel different from my other keycaps. So there is a very real disconnect between the two.
Oh, that's... So either get the full set or...
There is no full set. That's the problem.
But is there a similar set that feels the same?
I would like to find it if it does exist. But what I do like about it is that because they are completely metal, they are weighted really well.
So they look so cool. Like,
they are pretty. I mean, I'm looking at it and it's still pretty freaking cool. Like, it's absolutely ridiculous.
Can you hold your keyboard up to the camera?
Yeah, I mean, it's probably not gonna look good, but it's also like wires and shit. But
like it.
Where's my arrow keys? There you go.
When I saw the pictures on Facebook, I'm like, wow.
Wow.
I didn't think they were labeled at all, so I thought they were just completely blank.
Oh yeah, no.
But
these are
it's very fine.
Yeah, they're finely etched because if you have LEDs in your switches, they'll penetrate.
Ooh, oh my gosh.
Yeah, so nice. I almost wish I had a light-up keyboard at this point, but they Yikes. Feel, by themselves, they feel really nice to type on because they're weighted better, they travel a lot smoother, and for God's sake, they're all metal. I mean, it's just going to feel better than regular plastic. Yeah. It's just awkward because, yeah, I lose my positioning easily because I don't have the little nubs. And, like, I can definitely tell that, like, these keys will get all... Like, they won't rub down like the plastic will, but they'll... Like, they're all smooth and they'll get grimy easier just because they're completely smooth. Like, they're coated. But, I don't know.
Yeah, that reminds me of...
They're a nice novelty.
The only metal keyboard that I've ever, like, touched... I guess tried personally. My friend's dad is like a total Apple like fanboy fanatic, and Apple had this like I guess this like really old limited edition like titanium keyboard. Like, it's not mechanical, but they were all titanium keys in case.
Nice.
And
actually, there's really cool. Brushed aluminum and titanium exist in Cherry MX form as well, so I might have options in the future. Granted, I'd be spending as much to buy a keyboard to get these keycaps.
Yeah.
So, shit.
I don't know.
Anyway, Chase, final right. word.
I asked Twitter to give me some music.
Oh, yeah?
2 days ago. They super delivered. I found these two new artists that I'm, like, absolutely in love with. One of them is sister of Fairies member? Crap, I can't... Okay, so, first one is called... Her name is Kariasera. I always get the name wrong, but she's basically my age. She's an upcoming solo artist, and her sister is Miria Fujita from Fairies, I believe, and her voice is just like liquid chocolate to my ears. It's so good. I love her. I love her voice.
Liquid chocolate.
Her like, and she has this like cool like pop disco style, and yeah. So she has one single out. Picked it up. Absolutely love every track on it, and she has also been working in conjunction with this other like indie pop disco band called Give Me Wallets. And it's kind of cool. Like their whole concept is like they don't sing in Japanese. They only sing in this like cool in this interesting like bastardized English sentences.
Their pronunciations aren't bad either.
Yeah, it's just the guy's pronunciation is pretty Japanese though, but it's not bad. Yeah, and their music is amazing. I love their music too. I'll link you later, Dave. One of their songs is called "Looking for the Special,"
okay.
featuring Kariasera. Oh my god, I love that song so much. So yeah, yeah. Thank you. I forget who sent me it.
Damn.
Is it Jaro?
Jaro sent me Kamiasera. I forget who linked me.
Well, Gimme Wallets should have been connected to Kariasera.
Yeah, it was. She chimed in later. She's like, Kariasera is bae or something.
That's what she said. My favorite is her collaboration with Tofu Beats.
Oh, yeah.
She sang the vocals for So What, and that was, like, my jam for 2014, the whole year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I just love her voice. She's one of my new favorite vocalists. Her voice is actual liquid chocolate to my ears. So good. Yeah, no, Dell. Dell 48 linked me.
Oh, Dell is, like... master of the universe at times.
Yeah, Dell is my dude. So it was so good.
He is your dude.
He is my dude.
Yeah, I'm actually kind of surprised to hear that.
Why?
Knowing Dell and, you know, some of the stuff that he links.
Oh, God.
Well, we weren't talking about...
I think he's done with that phase, Draco.
I haven't seen him talk about idols in a while. We talked a lot about like Japanese noise music before, or just like experimental noise
music. I see him more tormenting Rena with like large boob gravure idols now.
Yeah.
Rather than some of the questionable stuff he used to post.
Yeah. I don't know. We've always had good discussions about music. Which is really nice.
I think Dell is mostly just a troll.
Oh yeah, of course. There's no doubt about that.
I'll link looking for the special in chat.
Okay.
It's been my jam for the past weekend. If you like indie pop and disco mixed together, this is your poison right here.
Okay. You should also watch the PV for Nobi Nobi Style.
Oh god. Yeah,
it's so cool.
Yeah, the PV, yeah, and Karya Sarah's first single Nobi Nobi No Style.
Oh yeah, no.
Is super. It's really cool. It's like sped up, and she's just like sitting on the train, and different strangers like get up and leave as the different stations pass by, and it's like the world's constantly changing around her, but she's like the one constant in it, and it's really cool, and the song's awesome too.
It's like this. She sits there for like the whole day.
Yeah.
Like slow motionly mouthing the lyrics, and then the video gets sped up.
I think
so that she looks like she's singing the lyrics.
Yeah, I don't know how they do that effect, but I know she's not just like slowly mouthing the words throughout the entire day. But
I mean, that would be true dedication if she did.
It's an effect. I don't know how they do it, but they've done it in multiple other videos as well. But yeah, it's a really cool PV. I'll link that one too. So yeah, this is I don't know. It was just really good music. Listen to Give Me Wallets and Karya Sarah. And I never remember her name properly. I always want to say Kamiya Arena or something for some reason.
Wow.
But Karya Sarah.
Yeah. It's because of those big boobs.
Not even. It's just the name is really similar for some reason.
Kamiya Arena and Karya Sarah?
Or Karya and Kamiya.
Karya Kamiya.
Yeah, I get it messed
Kamina.
Up.
Kamina?
Kamina. Kamina!
Big brother!
Yeah.
Bro.
Aniki! Big bro! Oh. We have to defeat the Spiral King!
Okay. Okay. Draco, what's going on? What's the final word?
Beetleborgs.
And Serena.
I like my new mouse.
Hold
and
it
I
up.
Have a closet now.
Hold it up.
Hold it
it's
up.
Like a, it's like a computer mouse, right? Not a mouse.
Yeah, it's a USB mouse.
What
USB?
Brand is it?
Amazon Basics?
Oh, okay. Shit! Amazon Basics?
Yo, that's an OG shit.
Wow. Yeah,
no, hey! Let me tell you, though, Microsoft made one of the best mice known to man. It was called the Wheel Mouse Optical.
Well, and... I mean, I just got it because it was cheaper, but, like, I actually really like the... I thought it was going to be, like, some really weird texture mouse, but it feels
Why
nice.
Would you buy it, then?
It's ergonomic, I mean.
I like it. It feels so nice. Like
At least you didn't get one of the ones that has a scroll ball on the thumb.
Oh yeah.
You know, you don't even like scroll with the mouse, you scroll with your thumb.
And it works well too because I sweat a lot, so this one's not slippery.
You're one of them sweaties.
Yeah. I get really my hands get really sweaty. But yes. Right. And I also have
spaghetti.
My TV now. And I have a closet. I have a closet.
Nice. Fully decorated. So when are you opening up the office so that we can start like filming
when I get rid of that couch and I get
why
a
so why
back.
Do you have that couch why
so,
do you have three couches
okay so this couch was in the living room right and
yeah.
We had four couches in the living room because one of them was supposed to be for we were holding it for our friend before they were moving into their house but then all of a sudden they said no JK so then now we have four couches in the living room, but we were having a party last night. So they moved that couch, this couch,
into
my
room.
So now I have three couches, and our house has six couches.
This is why you never hold stuff for other people. Because they go, JK, You can keep that shit.
I'm trying to get rid of it. Like, I'm trying to give it away to, like, some, I don't know, VSA member or something. But after get rid of that couch, I have that this corner space for, like, a backdrop or something. And I was going to use that. Yeah, I put my closet over here.
I'll just put it next to the dumpster. Trash will take it out some...
But this has memories. It's been with VSA for, like, 15 years or something.
Tell them it's going down the drain because no one wants to take it.
But it's super run down. Like, it's ripped.
I bet. 15 years of, like, club usage? Yeah, that's going to be gross.
Yeah. And I have this big bruise on my thigh because I fell off a table. Great. But yes, that's my final word.
Fantastic. All right, sounds good, guys. This was the NSK Podcast, episode 257. Join us next week when we talk about the benefits of consuming secondhand plastic appliances. All right. See you guys.